Welcome to the 2016 Stanley Cup Playoffs presented by Geico and the first elimination game in this series, Game 6, Panthers and Islanders. Hi, everybody. Welcome to Barclays Center. I'm Chris Cuthbert. Ray Ferraro is inside the glass. Neither team has won consecutive games in this series, and the Panthers will try and keep it that way tonight and force Game 7 Tuesday night in South Florida. Let's bring in Ray Ferraro on the ice in 93. Last time the Islanders won a series, David Volek was an unsung hero in that series, Ray, and the Islanders have plenty of those in this series.
If any team's going to have success in the playoffs, they need it from the top end of their roster, like John Tavares, and from unsung heroes, guys that don't normally score. In Game 3, Thomas Hickey, who had just 6 goals in the regular season, beats Roberto Luongo in overtime, and the Islanders took a 2-1 lead. In Florida the other night, Thomas Greiss was sensational. Just one playoff game prior to this series, he stopped Alexander Barkov in overtime on the penalty shot, and that allows Alan Quine to score on the second Islander power play of overtime to give the Islanders a chance to end the 23-year drought without winning a playoff series.
Panthers need offense. They're looking at Vincent Trocheck and Jaromir Jagr.
The feel-good story of the regular season was Jaromir Jagr. 66 points. Led the Panthers in scoring this year. 18 years of 25 goals or more. But his goalless streak has reached 36 playoff games. The Panthers are going to need something from the great Jaromir Jagr tonight. And Vincent Trocheck has been a sensational player for the Panthers this year. 25 goals on the year, yet he missed 4 weeks with a fractured foot until returning the other night in Game 5. He played 31 minutes, and he's going to have another big minute night tonight if the Panthers want to send this back to Florida.
The countdown's on to Game 6.
So welcome to the show. Bring on all the lights. Let it shine on you. We're together here tonight. Welcome to the show. Welcome to my life.
So the stage is set. Now time for the Honda starting goaltenders for game number 6. For the Panthers, once again, it's Roberto Luongo. 40 stops on Friday night. The Stanley Cup playoff record now at 34 wins and 34 losses. At the other end, one of the stories of these playoffs in his first ever series as a starter, Thomas Greiss, 47 saves in the 96-minute marathon. And look at that save percentage at .938. Jaromir Jagr now without a goal in his last 36, but he has set up goals in each of the last 2 games. And there's Frans Nielsen, who has 3 goals in this series. He scored the first goal of Game 5 and, as mentioned off the top, celebrating his 32nd birthday tonight. Ray, your first visit into Barclays Center, your thoughts on the atmosphere?
This is pretty good. They went and got loud in a hurry right before the anthem starts, and there's a lot of people in this building, Chris, that have been waiting a long time to see the Islanders punch through to the second round.
Even a few old enough to remember you setting up that overtime.
Yeah, there are a few old timers, that's for sure.
Icing call against the Islanders early, so Barkov on this faceoff in Islander ice against Nielsen, who prevails on the draw. There's Calvin DeHaan. Nielsen flanked by Josh Bailey and Nikolai Kuhlman, and back-to-back icing calls in the opening 15 seconds for New York.
One thing that'll be interesting to see for the Islanders, they've wanted this for so long. They've been so hungry for the chance to win. You see Calvin DeHaan, a young defenseman, ices the puck. There was no pressure on him. How quickly can they take the energy of this crowd and use it as a positive, not be nervous?
Barkov wins it this time. Brian Campbell's at the point. That shot was redirected into the corner. Alex Petrovic steps up. Loose puck here. Barkov has it swatted away by Calvin DeHaan. Here comes Jagr back in as his line mates start to change. Flipping it across for Jussi Jokinen. Jokinen takes a hit along the boards. He gets buried there by Travis Hamonic, and out comes New York. Opozo starting back. Jokinen dueling there behind the play as Luongo makes a glove stop off Opozo, and a chaotic start after Jokinen and Hamonic got tied up deep in Islander territory.
Chris, I ran into Bill McCreary, the supervisor of officials, longtime great official in the NHL. He said one thing that they have to be careful of is letting the scrums go after the whistles. Hamonic makes the hit on Jokinen. Jokinen's got a full grip on Hamonic's stick here. This is going to lead to the two of them getting in a wrestling match as the puck is gloved by Roberto Luongo at the other end of the ice. If the scrums start after the whistle, watch the officials take one player only for a penalty.
And the Islander power play has been a difference maker so far in this series. Only one power play for the Panthers in game number five. And Gerard Gallant mentioned staying out of the box here tonight. Hamonic able to knife it back in. Luongo stops it up. And now the Panthers start the breakout. Kulikov up on the left side. Jokinen sidestepped to check and got rid of it to center. Riley Smith's on the ice. He started with 8 points in the first three games. Hasn't collected one in the last two. Opozo curls inside the line. Threw it in front, and a puck was loose there. But Shane Prince unable to find it on that strange carom off a skate. Brock Nelson comes out. A pass on the right side for Logan Shaw doesn't work. Here's a little room for Steve Bernier back in. Bernier playing in his second game in the series. 9 hits on Friday night. Adding a robust factor and trying to center here for Nelson. Broken up by Matheson and played to center.
We saw a little glimpse of Mike Matheson's skating ability. Bernier had some room to tee it up. Matheson closed on him and the youngster made a really nice play.
There's Matheson with an area pass. Sean Thornton's back in the lineup after missing a couple of games. Out on a fourth line along with Garrett Wilson and Derek McKenzie. Here's DeHaan with a little backhand flip down the right flank. Clutterbuck got there first, so icing waved up as he beat Ekblad to the hash marks. Ekblad knocked that puck from the front of the net, and now Thornton dispatching it down the ice, knocked out of midair by DeHaan. McKenzie takes a wrap in front of the benches, and an icing call against Florida.
There's a lot of big people standing in front of me here, Chris, waiting to see what the call is, if there is one. Clutterbuck's on his backside. There's the Islander captain, John Tavares. What a series he's had. Just a terrific player. When you think back to junior and when Tavares was coming out of the draft, the criticism was that, is his skating going to be quick enough? He worked so hard on it. I was watching him in warm-up, the way he moves on his edges. His skating isn't a concern. His competitive fire, his maturity, when we talked to him this morning, he sounds like a guy that is really in control and is an acknowledged leader of this team.
And we talked about his improved defensive play that has been on display in this series. More on that as the game unfolds. Thornton to the red line, and he'll flick it in, bluffed down by Grice. There's Nick Leddy, who played an amazing 38-54 on Friday night. Josh Bailey to work, trying to set it up. Blocked by Taylor centering pass. Threw him to the whack at it. Bailey rolls it wide. Islanders looking for some offense out of this line with Kuhlman and Bailey without any production so far in the series. Josh Bailey's got it, leaned on by Petrovic. Up along the boards, dug out, and now Nielsen after it once again. The 51's looking for the puck. Campbell for Florida. Hamonic wants it, gets it, shoots it, knocked down in front, and Garrett Wilson's away. Soft chip down into the zone, and a wholesale change of players for Florida. Pretty good pace to start after the early icing calls against the Islanders. Florida has scored first in four of the five games. Franz Nielsen, the icebreaker on Friday night, and that puck deflects out of play. Time now for our Coors Light Cold Hard Facts, and we'll take a look at a couple legends, Jaromir Jagr, and who's the guy on the right?
Well, that might have told you what went wrong in that series for Pittsburgh. If Jagr came up skunked in Game 7 and I outscored him, then there was a problem. That series was magic, and that's what each of these teams are looking for here. They're looking for somebody to catch fire a little bit. Doesn't even have to be one of your main contributors, just somebody to come through in a big moment.
Eric DeBranson back in his own zone. Off the boards around and off Johnny Boychuk out to center. Vincent Trocheck's on the ice, and you mentioned it in the interview with Trocheck. Imagine coming back from being out 10 games. Gerard Gallant thought he'd play 8 to 15 minutes. He played 31 and a half.
Just a terrific skater, and Trocheck started the year on the wing, and when Nick Bjugstad went down with migraines in December, Trocheck moved in the middle of this line. They scored 17 goals in the month of March, Jokinen and Trocheck and Smith, before he had to suffer a fractured foot against Toronto.
Riley Smith on it there. Squeezed off the puck, and now the Islanders break out with Tavares. A return pass from Alan Quine, who's fit nicely on that line as Jack Capuano reconfigured the lines prior to the last game. Jokinen will flip it out to center. Boychuk will tee up and just send it around to the far side. Tavares after it against Young Ekblad, and Tavares comes up with it. 10 goals in his last 14 games without a point in game five. Up along the boards, it'll be flipped toward the net and blocked by Matheson, and out he skates. Michael Matheson has been very good in this series. 6 shots on Friday for the young defenseman. A giveaway here, and it's played by Barkov to Campbell. A shot right on, and Grace will hold on with Jágr knocked down in front.
Well, there is Jack Capuano. You mentioned he made a lineup switch, gets Alan Quine into the lineup. Quine was in Bridgeport just a couple of weeks ago. He made that switch because he had to move Franz Nielsen back to center because they had no depth of scoring in the third on their third line. Gerard Gallant's been juggling centers all over the place. First it was Trocheck, now it's Bjugstad. He basically is going with a three-center lineup and will use his Mackenzie, Barkov, and Trocheck along with Jussi Jokinen to fill in his third line between Hudler and Persil.
Asked if he'd have to pace his players after 96 minutes. Here's Kuhlman in, and that shot deflects wide. Bailey trying to center it, so Bailey and Kuhlman have been noticeable here early, trying to shake some slips, along with Franz Nielsen behind the net. Nielsen with 3 goals on the series. Trying to send it towards the net, off the skate to Campbell. Barkov knocked his man down, and the puck is played ahead onto the right side. Too far down the ice, and Campbell unable to reach it. He'll peel back into defensive posture.
Chris, you mentioned Bailey and Kuhlman struggling. Jonathan Huberto doesn't have anything for Florida. He looks a little frustrated already coming to the bench.
There's Yuri Hudler on the ice. Just 3 shots in the series for Hudler. They counted on him for more production than that. Will it come at the critical time here in game 6? Facing elimination. Big hit on the forecheck, but out comes Florida. Pass over the, or intended for Hudler, and the play offside at the line as Clutterbuck is leaking after getting a puck in the face.
In the mouth, you see the blood trailing behind him. He left with the Islander trainer in the break. It's been a tough couple of games here in game 5. He runs into Jaromir Jágr. Jágr runs into him. Clutterbuck sprawled out on the ice, so now Jack Capuano will have to maneuver his bench until Clutterbuck gets back. Talking to Doug Waite, the assistant coach, about possible line combinations.
He also ran into the elbow of Logan Shaw in that game, so it has been a rough couple of periods for Cal Clutterbuck. So he is off for repairs. Jack Capuano and Doug Waite sharing a smile on the bench as they have to put together perhaps a new combination or two until Clutterbuck returns. Don't miss a moment of the Stanley Cup playoffs with NBC Sports Live Extra. Streaming every game free with your TV subscription that includes NBCSN. Available online on the go and on connected TV. For details, visit NBCSports.com/Live Extra. Got the ice scraped up, and credit the ice crew here for quick work and getting this ice ready after a Springsteen concert last night. Dan Craig and the gang were here early today, getting it back in shape, and both teams were able to skate here this morning. Here's Derek McKenzie up to center, and a shovel clear in there by Sean Thornton. McKenzie on the forecheck, along with Garrett Wilson. McKenzie's got it, feeds the point, and Ekblad's stick snaps in half, and he has to head to the bench quickly as Shane Prince sends it down. Now Michael Matheson up for Jussi Jokinen, and a hit for Trocheck, who can't handle the pass. Quine was there defensively. Now up ahead for Opozo, hands it off to Quine. Alan Klein trying to dash inside the line, knocked off stride by Jokinen, and it's played back out. Klein, normally a centerman. That's where he spent the year in Bridgeport, where he scored 19 goals, but adapting to the wing with John Tavares.
Looked pretty confident there, didn't he? Slides it through the defender's feet and walks around him. Really good play.
I don't think any center is going to be too upset by moving to the wing with 91, are they?
No, if you're going to play the wing, it's pretty nice that that's the guy in the middle. The toughest part is you do feel a little boxed in on the wing.
What a nice play there by Huberdeau. He springs Trocheck a shot, and it's left stopped by Grice as Trocheck gets ridden out by Hickey, and now Klein in there, and a couple of feisty small forwards exchange shoves.
Klein comes back on the back check as he's as they get beat at the blue line. He's going to come all the way back. Trocheck snaps a pretty good shot here. Thomas Grice gets to handle the puck, makes the glove stop. Grice was sensational in game five. He had Michael Neuwirth put on a performance the last couple of games for Philadelphia. Grice stepping into the void here in New York and with the Islanders and having a fantastic playoff series.
Coming into tonight, 180 stops on 192 shots. Jágr off the draw, in behind the net, there's Huberdeau. This line with two goals off 67 shots in the series. Kuhlman with an outlet, and away goes Franz Nielsen. He'll flip it high, blockered away by Luongo. Petrovic takes a bump, and the Islanders get back on it. Josh Bailey, sharp angle shot, hit the side of the net. Nielsen recovers it, up high to the line, now swings it back in, Kuhlman behind the net. Up there by Petrovic, stays on the puck, throws away from the blue liner. Here's Bailey in front off a skate, and Barkov will recover. Flipped it ahead, and out comes Jágr and Barkov.
This line's had a couple of really good shifts. Kuhlman, Bailey, and of course Franz Nielsen in the middle, who does such a good job for Jack Capuano. And when they have a good shift, they're nose-to-nose against Barkov and Jágr. That means you take them out of any offensive dangerous positions.
Now Logan Shaw in on the forecheck. Calvin DeHaan sends it around. Matheson pitched in, but played to center. There's Matt Martin after it. Martin cut off by Ekblad. Following up, Cizikas. And right now, Steve Bernier, the third member of the Islanders' crash line in the absence of Clutterbuck. Cizikas taken down, and the officials don't react. You hear the response of the fans looking for a penalty. Cizikas turns it back in. Matheson closes quickly. Martin a shot, and that's off target. Held in at the right point by Boychuk. Now Opozo checks in and goes to work. Kyle Opozo on the prowl. Back in, block, rebound, glove stop. And Luongo holds on. A dangerous second chance for Opozo.
Really great effort by Kyle Opozo. The Islanders are changing. He's the only forward in the zone when he picks up the puck. You see Matt Martin's going off to the Islander bench. Opozo makes a spin off of the backhand that's blocked in front by Teddy Purcell, but Opozo stays right on the puck, and he's going to get to it first and test Luongo with a quick delivery.
Face off to Luongo's left end. From the drop, Islanders have it. Hamannik a shot. Big screen in front, but he sends it wide of the net. Kulikov up, and UC Jokinen at center. To the attack goes Trocheck. Drops it off, and Riley Smith one times it right on. Along the boards, Jokinen plays it in behind the net. Trocheck there, trying to feed the point. Get Branson shot it wide. Up and around, ready. Cut off there. Opozo checked by Riley Smith. Fit back to Kulikov. There's Big Gabranson trying to send it through wide of the net. Kulikov steps up again. Kulikov takes a heavy hit in the corner. Now he's got to get back defensively. Jokinen covering for him. It's Tavares working in. And the shot blocked by Gabranson.
What a defensive play. Yeah, what a great play, Gabranson. He's back there with a forward. He knows he's the last line of defense.
Playing the stopper role for the Panthers. Gives veteran Willie Mitchell a lot of credit for, as he said it the other day, straightening me out. Now it's kept in at the line and flipped into the glove of Grice. He'll put it on the ice and keep play moving here past the midway mark of this first period. Ryan Campbell up to Huberdeau. And Barkov gains the line. Drop Jogger. What a blast. And that went high over the glove of Grice. Pretty good look for 68.
They're on the ice here. Nielsen's line is not on the ice. And that's the first scoring chance for Jogger's line.
Now Petrovic ahead. He has stepped up offensively. Calvin DeHaan back in his own zone. Chopped up by Boychuk. And now the Islanders will leg it out. Here comes New York. It's Kuhlman over the line, overskates it. McKenzie unable to clear. DeHaan into the glove of Luongo, and he'll hold on. You're watching the 2016 Stanley Cup Playoffs.
Jack, you said this morning you were hoping your team could use the energy from the building and not be nervous. How's the start been for you?
It's been a great start for us. A lot better in the past. We're getting pucks in. We're getting more shots on net. So far, the territorial battle, I like what we're doing.
You're down a forward in Clutterbuck, and hopefully he returns. Are you just going to move some people around, stay with the four line?
We've kind of been used to this all year long, to be honest with you. So, you know what, we'll move some guys around. Hopefully he'll be back.
All the best, Jack. Good luck.
Thank you.
Jack Capuano mentioned this morning that come playoff time, you need luck, health, goaltending, and special teams. He's had pretty well most of that so far in this series. And hoping Clutterbuck gets back quickly.
That is a really good summation of the way the playoffs go. You can have the best team and somebody gets banged up, or a couple key people get banged up, or your goaltender goes cold and out you go.
Well, their power play has been dominant. The goaltending terrific. Panthers would argue they're not getting any breaks so far and looking for something as the series wears on. Here's Riley Smith into Islander ice. He gets slowed up by Hamonic. Pass to the point. Gudbranson gets a shot on, and it is blocked and ricochets back to center. Big Eric Gudbranson, and that deflects off a stick and into the seats here at the Barclays Center.
Chris, you're just mentioning Eric Gudbranson, another one of those high Florida draft picks. Kulikov, Bukestad, Ekblad, Huberdeau, Gudbranson, Barkov, all taken at the very top of the draft. But here's Alan Quine out. We talked about him being moved to the wing just a couple of weeks ago. Never really been a winger before. He's in really good position to block Gudbranson's shot.
A little bragging rights for Quine, because he and Gudbranson are training partners during the offseason, both from the Ottawa area. Puck shot wide of the net. They haven't talked during these playoffs yet, though, and that probably will continue until this series is done. Matt Martin working over a Panther. Garrett Wilson along the boards. Bernier in the fray. Puck comes loose. Cizikas takes a hit as the fourth liners are out and making some noise. Sean Thornton on the forecheck as it's played out to center. Loose puck. Barkov was nearly away, but Thornton was trapped inside the line offside. So Thornton to the bench. Barkov knocks that puck away from the blue line. And Franz Nielsen buys a little time to complete an Islander change. Pass intercepted at center by Matheson. Jaromir Jagr to work. Shot goes wide. Huberdeau on the far side. Now it's Barkov along the boards. Huberdeau in support, and Jagr's there as well. They get control. Here's Matheson sending it toward the net. Knocked down en route. Played back past Ekblad and out. Shots 5-3 Islanders as Matheson races back in. Trying to drop for Huberdeau. Didn't make the connection. Look out. 3-on-1 the other way. Here's a shot, and it was blocked by Gudbranson. And we've got a penalty upcoming. First call of the game is a hooking penalty against Florida.
Well, Matheson jumped into the play. And when he reversed the puck, nobody's there except the Islanders. And quickly up the ice, John Tavares has the chance. There's the hook on Jaromir Jagr as Oposo's on the inside. Jagr hooks him on the pants. Tavares' shot is blocked and goes to the corner. And the Islander power play, which has scored 5 times in 5 games, gets the game's first try.
This power play brought to you by USAA. Power play goals in each of the last 3, and 3 for 8 at home in this series. We've mentioned it a few times, Ray, in the series that Panthers were not a good penalty kill team during the regular season, 24th, and it has bit them so far in this series. Faceoff was won by the Islanders, but somebody moved prematurely.
So Nielsen will be kicked out. The Islanders have two centers on the ice. It's not that big a deal, but Nielsen had won the draw. So Tavares will come in against Derek McKenzie. McKenzie takes about 55% of the defensive zone faceoffs for the Panthers. And he was in the penalty box when Alan Quine scored the game winner in game five.
And from the draw, McKenzie prevails and clears. So Derek McKenzie, Riley Smith, first tandem up for Gerard Gallant on the kill. As the Islanders quickly work through center, Raposo with a hot pass that Letty was unable to control, and they're turned back. 6 minutes remaining here in the opening period. 30 seconds have elapsed in the penalty to Jagr. Here comes John Tavares. Following up is Raposo. Down low, Nielsen, the backhand goes wide. Nielsen with a pair of power play goals in this series. Jokinen with another clear, and Grice sends it ahead as the Islanders were in the midst of a change. There's Zydlinski on the ice. He's set up the Alan Quine overtime goal. Little veteran savvy there. Pump fake and then the pass. He's got a good shot and whipped that wide. And another chance for Florida to clear. Zydlinski, 39 years of age, the oldest to play a playoff game for the Islanders. Brian Campbell stopped that break in, and not much going on this power play with a half minute remaining.
Excellent mid-ice work by the Panthers.
Hickey wraps it around. Bernier looks for it on the near side. Shoulder to shoulder with Kulikov. Bernier back to the point. Boychuk doesn't have a shot. Bernier into the slot. Kulikov in front. And it's whacked wide by Cizikas. Nice pass by Kulikov, but Cizikas had it bounce on him. Boychuk deep again. Bernier unable to stop it up. And Jagr gets set to return. He's back on the ice. And a good early road kill for Florida. One shot for the Islanders on the power play. Screw skating Calvin DeHaan ahead onto the right side, past Matt Martin. Huberto trying to clear it to the line. And now out breaks Jagr along with Barkov and Huberto. Matheson the trailer. Matheson a shot right on. And Grice has got it and holds on.
The Islanders with a chance on the power play. Right at the tail end of it, Casey Cizikas takes the Kulikov pass, and he's going to end up bunting it wide to Roberto Luongo. Really an excellent penalty kill by the Florida Panthers.
Here's a look at the brackets with the Capitals prevailing today to advance against Pittsburgh. What a beauty that will be. And the Lightning await the winner of this series. Will it be over tonight? Do we go to Game 7 on Tuesday?
Each day is another day in the healing of Anton Strålman, and perhaps later for Steven Stamkos. That's good news for Tampa.
Josh Bailey has gone to the room for the Islanders. Now Clutterbuck has not returned yet. Bad angle shot there as Nielsen tested Luongo from around the goal line. And Barkov outlets. Petrovic returns it. Alexander Barkov stopped on a penalty shot in overtime. Threw it across here. Kulikov knifes it ahead. Huberto in front. Unable to get it towards the goal. And Raposo recovers for the Islanders. St. Paul, Minnesota native, flips it in. Gets dumped at the line as play continues. Good Branson around. Huberto unable to corral it the first time. Trying to clear it here. And out they come. Riley Smith flicks it in. And now Trocheck starts the forecheck. Nick Letty to the near side to fellow Minnesotan, Raposo. Dmitry Kulikov. How tight is this series? 13 goals apiece. Both teams with 2 goals and 9 assists combined from the blue liners. Just about everything's the same except the win total, where the Islanders lead by 1. But Branson sends it back in. Under 2.5 left here in the first period. Pass nearly cut off by Matheson. Cizikas, and now Bernier. In behind the net, it's Barkov there defensively, up against Brock Nelson. And he comes away with it, out at center ice. So here's Barkov getting a double shift. Without Nick Bjugstad in the lineup. Thomas Hickey, back in his own zone. Purcell lost an edge as he was trying to track Hickey. Matheson at center, stopping up Bernier.
Mike Matheson is an impressive young player. This Panther defense, outside of Brian Campbell, the next oldest guy is Kulikov. He's 24. They are going to be good for a long time.
Matheson just dipping his toe in the water at the NHL level. A couple of regular season games, and now 4 games in this series. Puck out of play. Mention the Barkov penalty shot that could have ended it. Here's the penalty, a strange one. Calvin DeHaan closing his hand on the puck and in the goal crease that gave Barkov the penalty shot.
Barkov has a move where he goes to his backhand and just slides the puck one-handed. This time he goes to the backhand, tries to get it over top of Thomas Greiss, who made the stop.
Just 3 penalty shots in overtime in Stanley Cup playoff history, and still no goals.
Got to remember, too, when a player deeks on a penalty shot in overtime, the ice has been shattered for about 70 minutes by this time. It gets a little harder to keep it flat, a little more difficult to raise the puck.
Here's Jussi Jokinen out at center. Out with Trocheck once again, 70 seconds remain in a scoreless opening period. Pass for Huberdeau, puts on the brakes, and shot, scores! Jonathan Huberdeau has his first Stanley Cup playoff goal and an icebreaker for Florida.
Couple of things on this goal. The puck is turned over in the neutral zone, and Jussi Jokinen's going to get the puck on the turnover to Vincent Trocheck. Watch Trocheck's hands. Huberdeau's shot's going to hit the leg of the Islander defenseman. The puck's turned over by Shane Prince in the middle of the ice. Jokinen finds Trocheck. Quick little move. And then Huberdeau's shot is going to deflect off of Nick Leddy there and goes up over top of the blocker of Thomas Greiss.
25 shots without a goal coming into this game in the series. Huberdeau breaks through. And for the 5th time in 6 games, the Panthers have the first goal. 18:58. Time of the icebreaker here with Jokinen and Trocheck drawing the assists.
So Trocheck makes a contribution here early. It's Jokinen's clever play to get the puck away from Shane Prince in the middle of the ice. And then Huberdeau, we're talking about him earlier, showing a little bit of frustration, I thought, even just a couple shifts into the game. The 20-goal scorer gets his first in the playoffs.
Yeah, he ended with a rush, too. 7 goals in the last 9 games, 9 in the final 16 to hit 20 on the season. And we'll see if that gets him going on that top line. Dying seconds of the period. Zidlitsky ahead, deflected in by Bernier. And that's going to do it for period 1 in game 6. Stay tuned for the Lexus intermission report with Catherine Anson and special guest Corey Schneider. They'll have a reaction to the Capitals and Stars advancing with series victories today. Jonathan Huberdeau, the goal scorer. Fast-paced opening period, maybe some nerves on either side. 1-0 Florida after 1 at the Barclays Center. 1-0 Panthers. Let's go inside the glass, presented by Progressive Insurance with Ray Ferraro.
we watch the game and we know that it's really fast. There's lots of players that can really skate. But what you can't see sometimes is the agility of the players. Look how Huberdeau stops on his right foot, pivots on his edges into his left, gets around Travis Hamonic and releases this all in one motion. We're going to get a look at it from center ice, and you're going to see the puck deflect off of Nick Leddy. Wonderful move by Huberdeau. His first of the playoffs is going to clip off the right shin of Nick Leddy up over Thomas Greiss. Strength and agility and a terrific shot for Jonathan Huberdeau.
Period territorially went against the green to play this series, as the Islanders actually had 26 shot attempts to 14 for the Panthers, but it's Florida with the lead. There's Cal Clutterbuck back, but Josh Bailey has not returned for the Islanders.
It was interesting listening to both coaches, Jack Capuano and Gerard Gallant, this morning. They both have said it seems like it never ends for their team. Capuano's had players out of the lineup. They're missing Anders Lee, who would be a big help to them in this series. And for Gallant, it's been Bukestad and Trocheck. They're two of their center, top three centers, that they can't keep in the lineup at the same time.
And go a little further back for the Islanders, who haven't had Mikhail Grabowski for some time. And with Anders Lee, a couple of offensive weapons that would look good in this lineup, as the puck's fired down on Roberto Luongo. Winding up Ryan Campbell. But isn't it strange, for five games the big edge in play has gone to Florida, and they're down in the series, and they get outplayed in the first period here but have the lead. Trocheck to work. First Stanley Cup playoff point for the former member of the Saginaw Spirit. Pittsburgh native in on the forecheck, rooted away from the puck by Nick Leddy. Played to the line and kept in by Jokinen. Trocheck has it bounce on him. And it's a Pozo with a little flip ahead that doesn't connect with Tavares. Tavares to the bench, Trocheck deflects it back in. Grace out to play it with Riley Smith lurking. And now it's Cizikas sending it out through center. A Pozo still out there with Klein. And now a Pozo sends it wide of the net. There's Casey Cizikas with it, Matt Martin, and Cal Clutterbuck back to work on this fourth line for the Islanders, coming off their best game in game number five. Clutterbuck to Hickey. Hickey puts it right through the screen of Matt Martin and right on the net. Now another shot from well out. Luongo the stop, and then gets bumped by Martin.
Really important here for Luongo to get a hold of the puck as the Islanders get that fourth line on the ice rolling a little bit. They have not been in the game together, as Clutterbuck was hurt so early. But Luongo made that stop on the deflection and then gloved a 35-foot floater with Martin on the prowl. That line can generate some offensive zone time. They scored some goals this year for the Islanders. As you mentioned, Chris, their best game in the series was game five.
Walked into the Florida room this morning, and as we arrived, Luongo was in the midst of an uproarious laugh, sharing a joke with one of the equipment guys. So we knew that the tension of game six in an elimination game wasn't getting to him. Veteran player, here's Shane Prince trying to beat Luongo, who shuts the door again and holds on.
A couple of sloppy moments for the Panthers. Luongo in good position to make the stop. As Ekblad has the puck, and he's going to go up the middle to McKenzie, but closed quickly by Brock Nelson. Now the puck's going to bounce around a little bit, and Prince is going to shovel this through to Luongo. You know, the overtime goal by Quine the other night was a nice shot on the power play, but Luongo probably should have had it. He pushed across on his knees. He was in position, just missed it with his glove, one that he doesn't normally miss.
Again, the puck dropped unfairly. And they'll do it again after a face-off win for Nielsen. That's a couple of times that's happened tonight for number 51. And from the draw, Barkov comes away with it. Fired down into the Islanders zone. Jágr goes after it. Didn't get a shot on goal in the first period. That hits Huberdeau. And Kuhlman heads north. Right side, Cizikas takes and then takes, and it went off. Matheson wide of the net. That could have been a dangerous ricochet. And an icing call against the Panthers.
Cizikas gets moved up onto this line. with the absence of Josh Bailey. Cizikas should shoot this here, but he delays for a moment, and the puck ends up getting deflected away. If he can get this onto the net, then it's Kuhlman's job to push through Brian Campbell.
So again, Cizikas, the fourth line center, but in the absence of Bailey, takes an extra turn. Just like the Panthers are in covering one of their center positions tonight. In the absence of Bukestad, Petrovic gets things organized. Campbell with the shoot-in, deflected deep by Jussi Jokinen. An assist in the first period gives Jokinen 4 points in the series. Up on the tape for Kwine, who was not able to control it cleanly. Trocheck ahead, back inside the Islander line, but not for long. Now here's Kulikov stepping up, unable to get a shot towards the net, and it's played back out to center. Saw Willie Mitchell. Oh, a giveaway, a poser in front as Gabranson lost the handle. It'll come back to the point. Hamonic sends it wide. Deflected. And Luongo's got that. And another egregious giveaway. That by Gudbranson. And he gets bailed out by the veteran netminder.
See Gudbranson just shaking his head as the puck is going to explode on him here. He goes to pass it and whiffs it. Oposo's going to get to it. One stop by Luongo. And then with all this chaos around him, Hamonic can't find a shooting lane to get the puck to the net. And Roberto Luongo has come up big with a couple real good stops here in the early moments of period two.
Shots now 10-5 in favor of the Islanders. Going to say veteran Willie Mitchell not available for Florida, but skating with the team. And that presence with the young blue line as almost a mentor coach at this point, as he's been sidelined by concussion problems. One of those veterans that young players talk so glowingly about. Matheson able to pull the trigger, and there's a stop by Grice. And a little activity, post whistle. Follow the Stanley Cup playoffs live with the official NHL app. Stay connected with in-game highlights, new score stats, and more. Download the official NHL app today for your phone and tablet. Little disturbance around the net, Ray, and look who comes out, Sean Thornton.
Quiet some things down a little bit, but it's interesting watching Florida, who really doesn't have four lines dressed, trying to play as close as they can to four-line game. With game five going so long, you got to guard against guys running out of gas here.
Asked Gerard Gallant about monitoring time tonight. Because of that, he said, we've just got to play, and we're going to empty the tank. Thornton with a shot off that right wing that got through on Grice. Ekblad seals the wall. Thornton goes to work along the boards. Jostling there with Brock Nelson. Clutterbuck in the middle of it. Little mano a mano, and the puck comes out to center. Knocked away from Martin. He gets it back, and he's got Brock Nelson in front, and it skipped on Nelson, who was in a pretty good spot in front of the net. So Nelson takes a turn on the fourth line after Cizikas had moved up, and now here's Nielsen, a pass and a stop there on a hot shot that Luongo looked good on. Steve Bernier let that one fly. Now the other way, a shot sails over the net that ricochets to center. Tapped at by Nielsen to Bernier. He'll chip and chase along the boards with Petrovic. Brian Campbell there as well. Puck loose for Kuhlman. Out of the corner he comes. And it's chipped out off the stick of Trocheck. Both teams making changes as Trocheck tried to halt the progress of Hamonic, who worked it ahead. Tavares stopped inside the line. Now the Panthers try to strike back. Jágr looked for it, but unable to come up with it. He'll chase Letty behind the net. Letty gave it away, and a quick shot turned aside by Grice. A turnover there, and Barkov got a whack at it. Now Jágr to the point on the backhand. Ekblad tried to feed it back. Knocked down by Tavares.
Well, Tavares can't get free at all. There is no room for him to get moving with the puck.
Now it's sent to center ice. Tavares told us this morning playing head-to-head against Nick Backstrom last year was a lesson in how well you have to play at both ends of the ice. And Tavares has demonstrated that this playoff round.
Well, after Gudbranson had burped one up at one end of the ice, Nicoletti's going to do the same thing here. He hands it to Barkov. Grice has to be sharp as Jágr gets his stick onto the stick of Letty and pushes the puck off his stick. Letty watching up on the board to see if he gets a look at it. See him averaging over 28 minutes a game. What a wonderful skater. He just glides on top of the ice so smoothly. Allows him to chew up some big minutes.
As mentioned, just under 39 minutes 2 nights ago. So Cizikas back out with Butterbuck on the line. As out breaks Ekblad trying to dash through and lost the handle. Johnny Boychuk will take over. Up at center, it's Shane Prince. We've seen some juggling here. Prince now with Butterbuck and Cizikas. Again, one forward down for the Islanders. Prince behind the net, the goal scorer in game three. A good collision there as Cizikas slowed up Logan Shaw. And an icing call against Florida. Well, tomorrow, 7:30 on NBCSN. It's Game 7, Blackhawks and St. Louis. Will there be a Game 7 in this series?
Chris, really interesting face-off coming up here. A run-of-the-mill icing. Of course, the defensive team can't change. But the Panthers don't have one of their three top centers on the ice. Logan Shaw's going to have to take the draw here. Jack Capuano comes back with the Tavares line, and Nielsen's on the wing here with Oposo. It's a big chance for Tavares and the Islanders.
Shot to 5-2. Islanders second period. Tavares turns, shot doesn't get through. 12-7 the shots in the game in favor of the Islanders, looking to equalize here in the second as Jokinen banks it down the ice. And another icing call against Florida.
It's been a tough first half of the game for Tavares, just not able to find much room to move with the puck. I wonder if 11 forwards, as Capuano starts to move some people around, if we'll see more of Nielsen and Tavares together on the ice.
21 points in his last 14 games. And a face-off win here. Oposo up with it. Here's Oposo trying to get to the net, and he is tricked by Matheson. And it's sent to center. Tavares back in. Watched by Matheson, who takes it off him, but a quick shot by Oposo. And that's batted away by Luongo. Luongo looking confident in the Panther net tonight. Up at center, pass Nielsen, sent back in by Trocheck. Panthers have to tag up on the onside. Here's 39-year-old Marek Zydlitski. He'll send it down the ice, and that's an icing call on a missed pass by the veteran Islander defender.
Yeah, he airmailed this through the middle of the ice, so the draw will come back down to the Islander zone. And after a first period that was frenetic, this one's turned a little sloppy here. And there's been turnovers at both ends of the ice. Nobody really generating any shift-to-shift momentum.
That a product of playing 96 minutes?
Oh, absolutely. You get stuck on a shift 5 or 10 seconds long and you're gonna feel the burn in a hurry.
There's Thomas Hickey behind the net. And it looks like another icing coming up as Petrovic got to the hash marks first. And we'll do it all over again down in the Islander zone.
Just pulls the energy out of the building too for the Islanders. They'd love to have a couple of shifts in a row where you can get these people back in it. You only trail by one goal. You've only given up 6 or 7 shots in the first 28 minutes of the game. You have to stay patient, but you don't want to get lethargic. Push the puck back up the ice, support the puck, and get some forecheck going.
Alan Quine on this faceoff. Barkov wins it for Florida. Here's the goal scorer, Huberdeau, behind the net. Huberto sends it across in front, and Barkov was watched by both Quine and Nelson. Battle along the boards, and Jágr comes up with a puck. Back to the point, Ekblad shot, it went wide. Thomas Grace without the stick. Somebody lost a glove as well, and quickly back in comes Ekblad. Ekblad spins it in behind the net. Hickey lost the puck. Barkov's got it back. Here's a push from Florida. A shot deflected, and Grace, with the stick about 10 feet away, holds on. Nassau Coliseum, and the patches the Islanders wear in honor of the late great Hall of Fame coach Ray. I know he is a special man in your life and career, and somehow was able to coax you to an impossible upset of the Pittsburgh Penguins back in 93.
You know, you hear all the time about, oh, he's a great coach, but a better man. Al was that. Just a titan of the game, just the most respected guy you could possibly play for. We were all so lucky to play for him.
If we get a chance, we'll let you tell the story of how he motivated you up against that powerhouse Penguin club. What was that pregame address like?
Well, he wrote both teams' lineups on the board, and it wasn't a very pretty picture for us Islander guys, because that was Lemieux and Jágr and the crew, and he said, why can't we play with them for one shift? Why can't we play with them for one period and one game? That's all we have to worry about today. And then as you sat around and thought about it, we thought, well, we can do that. I mean, we can't beat them all the time, but we won the first game and we moved along. Al just knew how to push the buttons.
Florida seems to be picking up a surge and a chance there as Jokinen gets robbed by Grace. Couple of good chances. Jokinen has the stick knocked out of his hands and looks for a penalty. Doesn't appear that one's forthcoming.
Another Islander turnover. This time Travis Hamonic blows a shoe. And then the puck is going to end up back in the corner. A little give and go. And Thomas Grice has to be sharp on the chance by Jokinen. And the reason Jokinen's wanting a penalty. Watch Clutterbuck, 15. As Jokinen reaches for the puck, he carves his stick in half. Gerard Gallant having a chat with the official.
Only had one power play the other night, trying to remind the officials that maybe one is due his team. Doesn't always work that way, but trying to plant the seed. Huberto here in Florida has picked up the pace. Jágr sweeps it wide. Gudbranson moves up. Barkov in the corner. Now Johnny Boychuk tries to clear it. And that one down past Gudbranson. Is that enough for icing? Yes, it is. So no change for the Islanders, who are stuck in their own zone approaching the midway mark of the second.
The shot attempts were 96 to 58 in game five for the Florida Panthers. The Islanders have a 14-10 shot advantage now, but this whole period has been played in this half of the ice. A couple of turnovers by Florida gave the Islanders a chance or two, but Florida's starting to really lay the barrier across the blue line. The Islanders can't get across the red line.
Barkov won the draw. Kulikov shot went wide. Recovered by Huberto. He centered it all the way back to the left point. Gudbranson. The pressure continues, and the Islanders maybe getting tired here under duress. A shot there that deflects up onto the netting. And New York will get a much-needed change.
The puck just can't be moved quick enough for the Islanders to get out of their zone. Tavares is going to lose the faceoff. Quick puck movement. Grice has now got to fight and battle for the puck. There's Huberto with a chance off the end boards, and eventually Barkov's shot is going to sail up over top of Thomas Grice.
So a face-off to the right to Grice. Derek McKenzie on the fourth line for Florida. And a face-off win by McKenzie. That shot off the target. In behind the net, Garrett Wilson battles. McKenzie up with it, looking for his first ever playoff series victory. Puck deflecting high and drops in behind the net. McKenzie's on it, tracked by Nielsen. First trip for the Islanders, but same Florida pressure. And now Jablonski trying to loft it out. It'll be clubbed down and held in here. It's Teddy Purcell in front. Shot goes wide. A blast by McKenzie from a dangerous spot on the ice, and finally out at center. Kuhlman lost it. Purcell's going to turn it back. Here's Teddy Purcell, the former Maine Black Bear. Same school that Jack Capuano went to. Puck played in front of the net, and Grice turns that aside. And now we've got a penalty, and that intense Florida pressure has created a hooking call against the Islanders.
Well, your team's come out and started to control the play a little bit. Are you happy in the first 10 minutes here?
Yeah, definitely. Like you said, after that first goal, our momentum's going our way, and we're putting pucks in the net.
So you've earned a power play here, your first of the game. What do you want to see from this group?
Well, I hope we shoot the puck. I mean, sometimes you try and get too cute, but put the puck to the net and get some traffic.
Thanks.
Thank you, Ray.
So Kuhlman in the box, hooking the call. Florida 2-for-12 on the power play in the series. One goal in seven tries at the Barclays Center. And Ray, a little momentum here. They have seven of the last nine shots in the period. 9-7 favoring Florida in period two on the shot clock. Islanders control the draw and clear.
They seem to be quicker to the puck all of a sudden. The Islanders scrambling around, can't make two passes to get out of their zone. And it's a big moment in the game with Florida on their first power play.
Four forwards with Trocheck, Smith, Jokinen. On the ice, big Brian Campbell, the old defenseman in front, and that was knocked down before it reached the net. Riley Smith, Yuri Hudler on this power play unit. And the veteran Campbell at the wheel, over 100 playoff games, over 1,000 regular season games. Trocheck in. Deflects to the far side, Riley Smith, Campbell returns it. Jokinen to Campbell, and now to the near side. Hudler right on. Just his fourth shot of the series. Campbell took a whack at it. It'll clear him back to Hudler. Reloading for Campbell. There's Campbell, and Hudler, a one-timer, heel wide, and Grice sprawls to cover with Trocheck in the neighborhood.
The first chance of the power play is Yuri Hudler's shot. The puck, you see it's rolling a lot here. They've struggled with the ice a little bit. The players have voiced their concerns about it over the last little while, but can't get the puck to sit down, and this one is a miscue, yet it becomes really dangerous. Those end boards are pretty lively. That's three or four times in this period that Grice has had to react to a shot wide of the net.
59 seconds remaining as the top power play group comes on. Barkov, Huberto, Jagr, Ekblad at the right point. And here's the goal scorer, Huberto, right on. Big rebound. Islanders up with it and send it out to center. 20-year-old Aaron Ekblad starts them back in. Pass to Jagr on the near side. 201 Stanley Cup playoff points for Jagr. And that puck comes back to Ekblad. He'll fire it through, knocked down in front. I think that hit Barkov. Huberto recovers. Battles along the boards. Help from Barkov to get it loose. Ekblad returns to Huberto, and now to the far side. Rink wide is cut off and cleared as Clutterbuck was in the passing lane. And out comes Kuhlman, so the Panthers unable to generate a cushion here with the first power play of the game. Fans respond to that, and offside the call.
No, the net's off.
That's
after
off. Okay.
Behind Thomas Grice. He waved his hand and they would let the play go if the Islanders were able to break up the ice when it was turned over. They blow it dead.
Like 68 was parked in front, causing problems.
Hamonic trying to keep him to the side. Jagr parks himself in front, looking for a rebound. Grice kicks it past Jagr. And the rebound is cleared away by Calvin DeHaan.
208 Stanley Cup playoff game for Jagr, matching a guy by the name of Gretzky, who also played 208 Stanley Cup playoff games. Or are you up for football next Sunday morning? League-leading Leicester City head to Old Trafford to continue their title push against Man United. Coverage begins next Sunday morning, 9 Eastern. The Premier League is on NBCSN.
Yeah, Yager's played 200. This is 208th game, and the Panthers franchise is in their 44th.
Remarkable tracking some of the accomplishments. Next assist ties him with Sergei Fedorov. Next goal was Jean Beliveau on the all-time list. Pretty good company, Hall of Fame company, and we know Yager will be in the hall. Once he ever stopped playing.
Yeah, first ballot, in you go. You just got to stop eventually.
So maybe 10 years from now. Here's Letty to the line. Nielsen was loose on the left side. The pass didn't arrive cleanly. And the Panthers work it ahead. See if that penalty kill has stifled the momentum Florida had generated here in the second period. Get Branson up. And now to work is Big Garrett Wilson. Check that Logan Shaw. Wilson on the forecheck on the other side. And along the wall, Petrovic sealed it up momentarily. McKenzie backs him up. Puck up off the ledge, and there's Shaw in again. Into the corner, and it's dug out by the Islanders. Barkov on it. Campbell swats it deep, and once again, the Islanders getting him. Down to 6 minutes remaining here in the second. And back to get it, Petrovic. Up off Nelson to center. Calvin DeHaan onto the left wing, and that was too far. Intended for Bernier. Brian Campbell wraps it around, and this is going to slide 200 feet. And an icing call against Florida. Let's go inside the glass, presented by Progressive Insurance. Here again, Ray Ferraro.
Experience is such a valuable thing in the playoffs, yet sometimes you see a young kid that just steps out with such poise. Here's Michael Matheson, who played most of the year in the American Hockey League. He's an unbelievable skater, great transitional speed. The number one pick of the Panthers in the 2012 draft from Boston College. He has been an outstanding addition to the Panthers. He added late in the year, and he's fit in perfectly on this young defense.
Averaging over 20 minutes a game in this series. Even Jack Capuano had some kind words for him, but he's biased. He's from Maine, and he said, good Hockey East player. And Matheson has opened a lot of eyes here in this series. Kyle Pozo to work. Sends it in. There's Alex Klein on the far side. Puck gets past him, and out comes Yager. And now over the line is Barkov. 20-year-old in the slot. Huberto fires, and he missed the target from a pretty good spot. Up the same range that he scored in the opening period. Checked in at the line by Kulikov. Rolled to the slot. Here's Barkov. A pretty good spot. Loose puck in front. Grace balls. Knocked it away from Yager. Still down, and the puck stays out.
I think Johnny Boychuk stops this. Barkov sails it into the front of the net, looking for a little saucer pass.
Can't get much closer.
Calvin DeHaan, 44, makes the glove stop on Barkov's pass, but then the puck's going to go to Yager's stick. Johnny Boychuk is there. He's strong on Yager's stick. And then Alan Quine comes in to push Yager over top of the pile, that close to it being 2-0.
Some desperado action in front of the Islander net that remains 1-0. Panthers on a first period goal by Jonathan Huberto. Amanek and Letty get things organized for the Islanders. And Letty through center. Knocked in by Matt Martin. Again, we have not seen Josh Bailey since midway through the first period, and the net knocked off here, and Matt Martin in the midst of it once again.
Aaron Ekblad's a pretty big dude. You can see him laughing as Martin just went straight over top of him and pushed him into the net. Ekblad's on the backside of Matt Martin, and instead of chasing the puck behind the net, Martin finishes the play off this way.
How about the Corsi for Ekblad in Game 5? He was on the ice for 23 more shot attempts for Florida than against. That's unheard of stuff, isn't it?
It really is. What a cornerstone player Aaron Ekblad is.
I wish he had a little extra time to pad those numbers, but eye-opening regardless. Here's Logan Shaw, ridden by Luddy, but stays on the puck at the side of the net. Shaw back to it. And now Luddy hounded there in behind the goal by Hoodler. Who's coming away with this puck? Loose, and there's Gabranson moving in. Trying to squeeze the vice a little tighter. Hoodler behind the net. Tied up there. And finally, Islanders claim it. Cizikas an outlet. Overbuck through center. Sends it wide of the net. Waterbuck at the side. It comes to the point, and Hickey unable to hold it in.
Hold on!
Islanders without a shot on goal in the last 8 minutes of play, and we're under 3.5 to go here in the second. Thomas Hickey ahead, and an offside call as Sheen Prince was a step ahead of Nikolai Kuhlman.
All the earmarks of a team that's a little frustrated. They no puck support, hold the puck a little bit too long, and then when you make the pass, you've put somebody offside. And as you mentioned, Chris, it's been quite some time since Jack Capuano's team has had a shot on goal. And at the very least, it'd be nice to have 3 minutes of play here you feel pretty good about before you go into the locker room.
14 shots on the night. 21 shots in their last home game here. A game in which the Panthers came back to tie the series at 2 apiece. Puck doesn't get through. Kuhlman turning it. Nielsen to the attack. Franz Nielsen over the line. Back to Kuhlman. Calvin to Hahn. Shot right on. Loose puck in front. Nielsen. Stopped by Luongo. There's back-to-back shots and chances for the Islanders. And a scrum ensues with Sheen Prince. De-helmeted it in front of the net.
One of the few times in the period the Islanders have strung together a couple of passes. The shot's blocked. Kuhlman finds Franz Nielsen, and look at Nielsen spread the defense. He pushes everybody back. Now he's got room to go to Kuhlman, out to DeHaan. And with that puck movement, the Islanders end up with their two best scoring chances in quite some time as Franz Nielsen comes across the ice to shoot the rebound. Good stop there on DeHaan, up high on Luongo. He stays in position, makes himself big on his knees to get upright and stop the rebound attempt by Franz Nielsen.
So Tavares comes out now to try and capitalize on a little momentum for the Islanders. Wins the faceoff. Letty look to get it back to him. That doesn't work, and Florida gets out. Riley Smith stopped along the board, but came up with it and is dumped. And here comes a penalty against the Islanders.
It's going to be a Poso for tripping. The puck turned over quickly in a reaction play by a Poso. He pulls the feet out. Right there of the Panthers forward, Riley Smith. And the second power play, second straight power play of this period goes to the Panthers.
So a couple of shots for Florida the last time with the man advantage. And here late in the second, a big opportunity to take a 2-0 lead. Jokinen on the faceoff, and now he gets waved. So it will be Trocheck. Butler, Campbell, and Purcell. Up to the line, held in by Campbell. Handed off to Trocheck. And that's going to do it for the power play as Butler going to get an interference call. And that's just 8 seconds in, and the veteran, the Lady Bing winner from last year, does not agree with the call.
Hoodler's argument is that Cizikas runs into him. It almost looked like Hoodler was surprised Cizikas is there. Look right here. But he does trip him up. The call's made, and we got 4-on-4 hockey.
So a little more room to operate. A face-off down in the Florida zone. And Gerard Glantz power play now 0-for-2. So So here's the chance for Jack Capuano, Ray, to double up Franz Nielsen with John Tavares. Started the series as line mates, and now 4-on-4 get put together. Probably the most dangerous pair of the series for the Islanders. Trocheck and Smith stay out, and a pass to the point. Sails all the way back into the Panther zone. Gudbranson. Now for Kulikov. Trocheck over the line. And that pass brings Gudbranson back out. Trocheck ahead, and now they're in with Riley Smith on his off wing. Knocked down by Letty. Up ahead it goes, and Nick Letty goes to work. Wide, and a little bobble of the puck, but in deep. Trying to drop to Nielsen, and that's cut off by Barkov.
What a smart play by Barkov. Read the play, intercept it. Now they're out of the zone.
And it's Jokinen out there with Barkov. Alex Petrovic's in deep. He's had a good series offensively, a game-winning goal. Last time in to the Barclays Center. Cautious 4-on-4, but maybe not for long, with Tavares flipping it wide. Barkov up with a rebound. Hooks the pass across to the smooth skating Gamble. Over the line with Jokinen. Around it goes, and Zydlitsky gets there first. Kept in at the line by Campbell. Final minute, second period. An outlet for Shane Prince. The Rochester, New York product plays it in. Brock Nielsen after it. Prince followed up, and down the wall came Hickey. He may get caught, trying to come back, and Thomas Hickey catches up to the play at the Islander line. Zydlitsky with a little burst. Pulled away from Huberdeau. He walks in, leaning now on Campbell. Out of the penalty box comes Opozo. Very brief power play. Kepdeep Cizikas sends it wide of the net. Couple dozen seconds remaining, and now it's Hoover out of the box. Full team back to full strength. Point check with a hot shot. Moving up is DeHaan. Up along the boards. Pulled down there by Opozo and flipped away by the Panthers. And time's going to run out here in the second period. And the Huberdeau goal stands up through 40 minutes. Another goaltending duel between Greiss and Luongo. As the Islander fans try to urge their team to a series clincher tonight, while the Panthers try to stave off elimination and force Game 7 on Tuesday night. A look at the series and the way it has trended. The Islanders have led for under 50 minutes. Florida tripled that amount, and we've been tied for a great deal of a tightly contested series where both teams have scored 14 goals. Here's Jágr, and a shot off the shoulder of Grace early in this third period. Puck out of play, 17 seconds in.
Jágr almost ended his 36-game goal-scoring drought in the playoffs in the second period, and he gets a great chance here that just catches the left shoulder of Thomas Greiss.
Hard to believe it's gone on that long.
Amazing, actually, especially considering how well he's played the last little bit, last couple of years, really.
Over a point a game down the stretch, it's not like he was faltering or getting tired, and he has been busy in this series, playing almost 21 minutes a night. Away goes Barkov along with the goal scorer Huberdeau, who missed the pass. And the Islanders will take over and get organized. John Tavares, one of six Islanders without a shot on goal so far tonight. Wrapped in by Boychuk. Kulikov after it, the senior man on the Florida Panthers in terms of service with Florida. Kamenik got a little trouble with that and swings it back in behind the net, centered by Trocheck. Smith a shot and a big stop. Thomas Grace with a huge save off Riley Smith after a giveaway by Kamenik. Panthers back to work. Trocheck to the line. Kulikov sends it in. Kamenik cuts that off. Plays it up ahead for Opozo, but not out. Spun back by Trocheck. Here's Vincent Trocheck. dishing for Jokinen, and that shot off Grace with Riley Smith on the doorstep. Good start for Florida in the opening 90 seconds.
And this all was off another Islander turnover where they had plenty of time to make a quality pass. They didn't. Now they can't get the puck back.
Logan Shaw out there along with Hudler and Purcell. Cizikas able to make the pass that gets the Islanders out. Nick Leddy to work. Dishing it off. Matt Martin, a weak backhand that hit Leddy, who jumped up on the play. Shedlitsky sends it in, and Gudbranson got fooled by a strange hop off the stanchion. Purcell there to help him out, but not out. Shedlitsky into the slot. Clutterbuck stopped, and a big save by Luongo. Shedlitsky holds his own, and now the Islanders press. Matt Martin behind the net. Warding off Michael Matheson. Got it loose. Cizikas centers. Another stop. Two in a row by Luongo off Clutterbuck. Wow.
Well, we just finished talking about the Islanders turning the puck over. Now it's Florida's turn to turn it over. Teddy Purcell's pass is too far for Matheson, and Cal Clutterbuck's going to get a shot from 25 feet. Luongo swats it away, and then as the shift continues, this is a better chance. Cizikas right on the tee for Clutterbuck, with Martin getting to the front of the net, and Roberto Luongo is sharp to make his 19th stop.
That fourth line for the Islanders yet to score in the series. They haven't had better chances than that. Alan Quine now centering Shane Prince and Brock Nelson. So Jack Capuano has made a change, getting Quine off the top line. See if he loads up Franz Nielsen with Tavares and Opozo. Back to Brian Campbell. In for Barkov. Using his side to ward off a check. Jágr in support along the wall. Huberto steps in. Johnny Boychuk on the far side, backhands it ahead. Shane Prince can't get it out. Now the Islanders will advance. Past 3 minutes of the third. Luongo unable to stop it up. Here's a giveaway as Prince comes up with it. He gets knocked down. Erased from the play by Ekblad. Both teams change as Nick Leddy starts back. There's Nielsen. He is with Tavares and Opozo. Tavares, Leddy, shot, blocker stop. Another good chance for the Islanders. That off the stick of Nick Leddy. So Roberto Luongo getting tested here in the opening 4 minutes. Puck high into the air, and Jokinen bats it back into the Islander zone. It's as solid as we've seen Luongo in the series, Ray.
And not much bouncing off him. Everything directionally pointed to the corners. Looks super comfortable in goal.
Grice steered that away. Now up for Tavares. Leddy can't get it out. Turning it back. Garrett Wilson on the backhand, and that goes wide. Around it comes, and the captain's got it. Gets to the red line and sends it in. That line changing for the Islanders. Tavares still fencing along with Garrett Wilson as it comes ahead for McKenzie with speed. That shot into the glove of Grice, and he'll hold on.
As the Islanders try to get some offense, one of the biggest problems is they've not managed the puck very well at all. They've had it under control and then just handed it away. So not only do you lose the puck, but now you got to go get it back. Here's the most dangerous one here in the third period. Hamonic hits the back of the net, forces Grice into a terrific stop. The game's only goal came off a turnover just outside the blue line.
Remember, three goals in 96 minutes 2 nights ago, just one here so far tonight in the opening 45 minutes of play. Out comes Cizikas. Back to Clutterbuck. Zidlicki had moved up on the play. John Thornton took a whack at his man, and Cizikas on it again. Islanders fourth line trying to put together back-to-back dangerous shifts. Glove pass will halt play. Time now for our player profile with insights from SAP, and we have had unlikely heroes in this series. Who's going to be the hero tonight? Thomas Hickey, an overtime goal, as Alan Klein delivered on Friday night, and Alex Petrovic with a game winner in the last game here at the Barclays Center.
Well, with so many young players in the series, there's going to be a lot of first-timers. Jonathan Huberto has the only goal tonight. It's his first goal in the playoffs.
Interesting hearing Jack Capuano talk about the young players and the lack of entitlement, the way they approach this as a chance to make their mark. And a lot of them have done it so far in this series. Purcell across, Campbell a shot right on. And we're told that Jaromir Jagr is no longer on the floor to Panther bench. He's gone to the room. Here's Huberto with a bad angle shot. Purcell out on that line. Riding shotgun with Barkov and Huberto in the absence of Jagr. Brock Nelson back in. Long range shot is blocked.
A lot of times the team won't know a guy's gone off the bench. He went at the last commercial.
If Trocheck works his way through. Drop it on his front. And that is tapped wide of the net. Alan Klein sends it ahead. And the Islanders work it out.
Get into Barclays Center here. The players don't leave the bench into their dressing room without leaving the ice. Jagr had to skate to the end of the ice and go out the end doors.
He's joked that he's 50. Maybe he needs a little oxygen here. Bouncing on Steve Bernier, who sends it back toward the net. Alan Klein to the point. Travis Hamonic sends it in. Oh, a funny hop there. And that pinball right on to Luongo. Saturday, May 7th on NBC with Nyquist, curiously enough, the favorite rain at this time. Amping it up at Barclays.
They're just looking for something, aren't they? Just a little bit of momentum.
But a quick breakout the other way. Logan Shaw lost the handle, and Jedlinski recovers. Nearly a two-on-one right off that face-off. Here's a Pozo! Glove stop! Luongo flashing leather.
Pozo ends up with a pretty good play here. Jaromir Jagr coming back onto the ice. But watch this play by Franz Nielsen in the middle of the ice. 51. The pass is behind him. He stops it with his foot, and that allows Pozo to go through the middle of the ice for the save. Chris, one thought about Jagr here.
Another Pozo shot, and Luongo has another stop.
A lot of the players now use the blades, the switch-it blades, that they can just take off on the bench and put back on. Jagr does not.
Old school.
Because he's 40-plus years old, he probably uses an old pair of skates. Like, look at those things. The new blades, those guys are, they're on and off. It's like a pit stop for a car at a race. They come to the bench, they flick them off, they stomp them back on, and out they go again.
Shots even, the Panthers try to even the series. Faceoffs were good even as well through 40 minutes. Really not much to choose between these two teams.
Regular season, the Panthers had three more points than the Islanders. They won their division. The Islanders were a wild card team.
Pozo trying to take that shot through a screen and up onto the netting. And while the Panthers were just a little bit better during the regular season, John Tavares and company with just a little more playoff experience.
The Islanders won 25 games in their first season here at the Barclays Center, but they started off rather uncomfortably. It looked like it was a new place for them. They closed out 12-3-3 at home as they got used to the new building.
Nielsen threw a screen, hit the traffic in front, and the Panthers with a quick clear. So a pushback here by the New York Islanders. And here's Pozo once again, has his pocket picked by Jagr. Good defensive play by the old guy, and Huberto turns. Jonathan Huberto with Barkov. Can't break through, and it comes out to center ice. Dispatched back into the Islander end by Brian Campbell. 7:40 gone, third period. Jonathan Huberto with 1:02 left in the first. The only goal scorer so far tonight. Campbell up off the glass, and that's out. Wojciech has trouble with it outside the line, but does get it back into the Florida zone. Campbell ahead, deflected by Shaw deep. Calvin DeHaan back for New York. Up the wall, and there's Campbell to seal it. Garrett Wilson up with it behind the net. He is erased. Huge hit by Wojciech. Cizikas an outlet, and Calvin DeHaan's got room. He'll flip it in, batted away by Petrovic. Sent back in by Cizikas, he wants a change. 8.5 gone here in the third. Out comes the veteran, Jussi Jokinen. Onto the right wing, that doesn't work, and it puts the play offside.
Nielsen, who has been very effective and noticeable again tonight, his shot hits Oposo and Gudbranson before it gets to Roberto Luongo, and there's Jágr, uses his reach and strength to stymie Oposo, and then he gets some help on the back check.
15,795, another playoff sellout here at the Barclays Center. Getting louder in the third period. Fans here hoping to see the first series win for the New York Islanders since 1993. But lots of work to do. Centering pass, and that was blocked in front. Matheson in the lane, and Matheson finds it and clears it. And up over top, a penalty coming up on an interference call as Riley Smith was sent somersaulting.
Thomas Hickey thought the contact was close enough to the puck going past him. See, the puck has gone a long way. Now, this is in slow motion. Hickey hip checks Riley Smith. But the puck is a considerable distance away. We look at it in real speed. The puck's going to come back and go through Hickey. You see, even though the puck is a long way, that happens pretty quick. But that's definitely an advantage that was taken away by Hickey. He's called for interference. Florida, third straight power play.
0-for-2, the last one only took 8 seconds before they were penalized. Clutterbuck hit hard along the wall by Aaron Ekblad. Barkov defers, and now young Matheson, former captain at Boston College, ahead. Barkov over the line, and he'll go after it. Out there with Huberto. And Jágr. Kamenik tying up. Huberto behind the net. Loose for Cizikas. He's closed down quickly and can't get it out. Kamenik will fire it around. And a good Islander hop brings the puck out to center.
I'm constantly amazed at how young this Florida team is. Look at this power play that started. Matheson, Ekblad, Huberto, Barkov, and then Jágr. That's four really, really young players.
And we're going to call their names in the Stanley Cup playoffs for a long time. Near giveaway there by a veteran, Brian Campbell. Muffed the pass, but he gets bailed out by Riley Smith. And now Campbell fires it down. Smith first man to it. Got to get it back to Jokinen. Now Kulikov. And Campbell shooting, and that's blocked. And cleared by the Islanders. 40 seconds left in the Hickey penalty. Under 9.5 to go in the third. Brian Campbell at the wheel. Up ahead it goes, Jokinen into the line, and the play is offside.
Well, the Islanders' fourth-rated power or penalty-killing group from the regular season hasn't allowed anything. Really, no zone time whatsoever. They've been aggressive to the puck. They force an offside here. And this faceoff will be outside the blue line as that power play is just whittled away with really no danger. 29 seconds left.
Islanders went from 29 to 26 to fourth in 3 years on the penalty kill. under Greg Cronin. Video every day for that group. And they've done the job again. Unless something happens in the last 10 seconds. Here's a bad angle shot that ricochets back, and Tavares is on it. With a burst, John Tavares in. Puts on the brakes. Now the Islanders at full strength. Point shot. Shot. Loose in front. On the Luongo Snow Angel. And it's underneath him for a faceoff.
Drives Aaron Ekblad wide, and Johnny Boychuk can really hammer it. Luongo through the traffic of a postal, and Matheson makes the pad stop. And then he's got a battle as he's going to get pushed over. And the puck is sailing there, or sitting there in the crease, before it's covered up. No shots for Tavares. He had 24 shots in the first five games of this series.
His line mate, though, Kyle Okposo, has seven in the game.
He's been the best Islander tonight, I think.
And again, in this third period, Franz Nielsen, celebrating his 32nd birthday, has been reunited on that top line. They diversified in game five and now have loaded up once again. Here looking for the equalizer tonight. An icy call with 8:17 to go, third period. Don't miss a moment of the Stanley Cup playoffs with NBC Sports Live Extra, streaming every game free with your TV subscription that includes NBCSN. Available online, on the go, and on connected TV. For details, visit NBCSports.com/LiveExtra. Well, they face it off at center. Throw check out with Jokinen and Smith. And another offside at the Islander line.
Well, Vincent Trocheck, a couple of days after playing 31 and a half minutes in his first game in a month, had a really brisk start. I think it's caught up to him a little bit here, Chris. He's not had as much bounce in the last half of the game.
Just over 17 minutes tonight, Ray. But not unusual that the second game back is a little tougher, especially when the first one was a double overtime marathon.
Well, you know, the coaches plan out their minutes before the game, what they'd like each guy to get. And there's no way Gerard Gallant wanted to play him 31 minutes, but the game dictated it.
Here's Jagr turning it back in. With a shot through traffic there that got to the net. Play to the point. Campbell bounces that to the far corner. Matt Martin turns it ahead. Off Clutterbuck, who had a couple of great chances early here in the third period. Now Trubisky intercepts a pass at center. Holds on to the puck, gets knocked off it, and Huberdeau back in. Huberdeau, and a glove stopped by Grice, who holds on.
I think we got a penalty here. Jonathan Huberdeau is going to get whistled for a high stick. It's a careless penalty for Huberdeau to take, certainly at this time of the game. He's going to take a long shot from the blue line that Grice will easily snare. Can't believe it, but watch Huberdeau's stick. It's going to catch Thomas Hickey in the face right there. Hickey sells it as the stick gets up. Huberdeau cannot believe it. And a gift power play. Gerard Gallant was shaking his head the other night after the Islanders got two power plays in overtime. The Panthers have had their power plays. They've come up empty. We'll see what the Islanders do here.
Faceoff won by Florida. So the third power play of the night for the Islanders. 5-for-20 in the series. Letty gave it away. And gets bailed out here. Franz Nielsen to work. Red line and in. Luongo unable to stop it up. Okposo down the wall. Chance for McKenzie. Trying to tie up his man. And the puck is picked off and cleared by Riley Smith after the initial pressure by McKenzie. Advancing is Letty, already over 20 minutes on the night. Fired around to the near side, looking for Tavares, back to Okposo. Nick Leddy in the middle. Tavares, shot, pad stop, rebound. Larocco with another save. And it's sent to the boards where Tavares comes up with it. Two more stops for Larocco. Here's Tavares down low. Nelson across, sliding block. Big play, Petrovic, and a clear.
Well, they had that set up perfectly to Oposo. Petrovic, a nice diving save.
Bounced into the corner, Leddy advances. Centering it, it bounced off Nelson. Look out, breakaway. Barkov's away. He's got a man with him. It's across for Smith, backhand, and it goes wide. Close call, short-handed. And now, 24 seconds remaining for the Islanders with a man advantage. They've had some chances, but gave up one. Short-handed. Last call. Thomas Hickey ahead. Pass broken up at the line. Thomas Hickey trying to get it back. Good Branson, a swipe at it. Along the boards. Panthers getting set to return to full strength. That's Kuhlman across. Jedlicki shooting it. Doesn't get through. In the slot, Kuhlman. What a stop! Roberto Luongo. Off Nick Kuhlman. Florida back at full strength. Huberto can't clear. Going to be Jedlicki once again. Working his way in, across in the slot. Knocked to the line and out. Wow. 5 minutes to go, third period. Islanders doing everything but tie it. And now Florida relieves the pressure and DeHaan back to get it. They talk about momentum after a power play. Let's see if the Islanders are able to keep it fired up. Out comes Boychuk to the red line, but stopped there. And Logan Shaw's got some room. Here's Shaw in, fires right on. And Bryce has got that. You're watching the Stanley Cup Playoffs, presented by Geico.
Dead center from about 30 feet. Luongo through the traffic. Blocker stop. And then the puck bounces out to center ice. Barkov tries to feather a puck over to Riley Smith. Nielsen gets back to deflect it. Grice turns that away. And then Luongo again on the Tavares shot through the screen. Brock Nelson another try. Luongo's able to push that away. And the Islanders have really pushed hard here lately. And Luongo's been letter perfect so far.
Twice in the series, Ray, 40 saves or more for Luongo, but I think this is his best night of this series. Barkov on this offensive zone draw for Florida over 21 minutes tonight. Up against Franz Nielsen, who prevails. Nielsen back with Kuhlman and Cizikas, unless he was just out to take the draw. Well, he's staying out there.
Yeah, this is an interesting line. Jack Capuano's running about eight forwards here. They're just looking for something that works.
4 minutes left. Barkov over 21 minutes on the night. Out again with Jágr. Cizikas comes up with it. Watched there by Ekblad. A battle and a shot. Shrugged away by Luongo. Rebound comes out in front. And he'll pounce on that with 3:41 to go.
After a really quiet series, Nikolai Kuhlman much better here in the third period. He's had himself into the middle of the ice a few times. Here he is battling with Michael Matheson in front of the net. This high shot's gonna hit Matheson, but it's Kuhlman who gets to it first. He's gotta settle it down, and he tries to go to the back door to Cizikas.
Kuhlman, a former 30-goal scorer with just one in his last 19 postseason games. Tavares on the draw, but Florida up with the puck. Pass for Jokinen doesn't work. Now to the far side, and there's Gabranson pushing it ahead. Riley Smith can't get loose, but following up is Trocheck. Vincent Trocheck cycles it down low. Smith unable to corral that. Hamonic tries to knife it ahead. Riley Smith back on the puck against Leddy. Tavares up with it. Slick outlet and the pass out to center off a stick, and Florida regains it. Here's Kulikov, deflected in by Purcell. Around for Opozo. You would think the line that's going to tie it for the Islanders, if they could do it tonight, is on the ice right now. Here's Hickey. Tavares and Opozo. And Cizikas now out with that tandem. Here's Jablinski shooting, and it's blocked. Derek McKenzie in the shooting lane. Tavares from the corner. Jablinski at the point. Plays it back in behind the net. Campbell is pumped there and dispossessed by Cizikas. Cizikas tried that short pass that doesn't arrive for Tavares. Brock Nelson out now. And the Panthers will clear. 2:15 on the clock. Panthers got a change in. Islanders in the midst of 1-2. Won't be long now till Grace, you would think, will be left it for the extra attacker.
They're going to have to do this on the fly if there's no whistle here, so communication is vital for the Islanders.
Now Capuano goes with Opozo, Nielsen, and Kuhlman. Got the blender going there at the Islander bench. Trying to get something done offensively.
He's waving for Thomas Greiss here.
And Greiss will leave the net, 100 seconds to go. 1-0, Islanders the lead, and an empty net. Along the boards, Trocheck up with it, trying to clear it. Bounces to the line, and I think that puck came out, yes. Delayed offside, so the Islanders have to tag up. That allows the puck to deflect it down the ice, wide of the net. Riley Smith goes after it against Letty. Up along the boards, Trocheck may get a whack at it here. Vincent Trocheck drops it off. Here's the shot, Smith in front, and it rolls wide. Close call, but the Islanders still have life. Up comes Letty in the final minute. Nick Letty centers. Luke Pavlovanko scores!
Sees him. Luongo makes a great stop and just sitting there. And as you said, if there was going to be anyone that was going to score for the Islanders, Tavares would be in the middle of it. And the Islander captain comes up huge. Oh, Luongo made a brilliant stop on Kuhlman. Tavares waiting to punch it into the net.
From our vantage point, it looks like it was covered. John Tavares knew otherwise.
Thomas Greiss sitting on the bench getting a drink of water while everyone else around him jumping up and down. The goal is a good goal.
He scored goals in game 1, 2, 4, and the biggest of the series for him comes in game 6. And we're under a minute away from the third overtime of this series.
On the Panthers came tantalizingly close, Riley Smith to scoring on the open net just moments before.
Are we headed for extra time, or is there last minute drama still to come? That fourth line reunited here, Cizikas, Clutterbuck, and Martin. Let's bring back memories, right?
It sounds exactly the same. I know it's a different place, but this is what it sounded like.
Final 15 seconds. There's Huberto intercepting. Up ahead for Barkov. Panthers in desperate need of a silencer here now. Here's Barkov ahead. One last shot, bouncing through. And we are headed to OT.
Remember, the Islanders couldn't get a stoppage. Tavares was just sitting on the bench, standing up, wanting to get on the ice. and he doesn't get on the ice till under a minute left. Aaron Ekblad has a chance to win this on the empty net. Stopped by Nick Leddy, and then Riley Smith is right there, and the puck just trickles by. As Leddy rushes the puck up the left, the right side of the ice. Look at Tavares, he's still not on the ice. Finally, he takes an exhausted Kyle Aposo. The Panthers are focused on the puck. Luongo makes the stop. It's just sitting there. And John Tavares is on the spot to send this game to overtime. What a brilliant save by Luongo. And fortunately for the Islanders, their captain was then on the ice to punch this into the empty net.
Stay tuned for the Subway Overtime Intermission Report with Catherine Anson and special guest Corey Schneider. Islanders forcing overtime here in Game 6. Much more. What a brilliant performance by Roberto Luongo, and for the time being spoiled by John Tavares. This is unfolded. There was an empty net goal in Game 2, so effectively one goal games. We've gone one overtime, two. Are we going three tonight?
The net is empty. Vincent Trocheck passes the puck to the point. He was tripped up, and the play doesn't go in. John Tavares can't get on the ice till under a minute left. Nick Leddy makes this beautiful, bold rush. He throws it to the front of the net. We hear all the time, drive the net, drive the net. Matt Martin drives the net. He ties up Ekblad. Kuhlman's shot is stopped by Luongo, and the puck trickles out. That puck is never frozen, and John Tavares is on the spot to punch it into the middle of the net.
Panthers have lost seven consecutive Stanley Cup playoff overtimes. Thomas Hickey, Alan Quine, heroes. Who's tonight's hero? Puck immediately sent out of play. Well, there's one of the heroes of the night to force overtime.
Didn't have a shot for most of the hockey game. Had 24 in the first five games of the series. And he ends up being at the right spot at the right time, gets to the net, and is able to beat Luongo to the loose puck.
Next goal wins. Tucked into the glove of Grace. He won't take any chances. Last time the Islanders won a playoff series overtime. Do they do it again in an extra session 23 years later?
That will be something they never forget if they do.
Alexander Barkov on this faceoff with Jágr. Along the boards, kicked there by Petrovic to hold his own. Jágr along the wall. Kept in again by Petrovic. Now Huberdeau's got it. An outlet for Barkov. Jágr looking for it, but the Islanders are on it. Pulling it away. His best game of the series. That puck sent in, and back behind the net, it's Steve Bernier crashing in there. Here's Bernier with Quine. A couple of days ago, it was Quine that ended it. He's got it now. Playing it for Leddy. Nick Leddy is shot, and that goes off Luongo to the right point. Kamenik plays the carom off the back of the net. Played ahead, and Leddy holds his own. Early Islander pressure. Aposo's on the ice. Tavares to Leddy, and Aposo with the deflection that goes wide of the net. Quine still on the ice. They jam along the boards. And out with it comes Florida. Panthers through center, and Barkov dispatches it into the Islander zone. On the change, it's Leddy moving ahead. That's deflected, knocked down with a stick that's ruled to be not too high by Trocheck. Kamenik at center, firing it down into Panther ice. It comes around for Jussi Jokinen. Looking across to the far side, and Riley Smith will send it in. Smith had that chance with the empty net just prior to the equalizer. Here's a steal. Jokinen's got it. Jussi Jokinen, and that shot wide. Up comes Gudbranson. Big Eric Gudbranson hit behind the net. On it is Trocheck. Logan Shaw to work. Fresh legs with Shaw not seeing the ice time of many of the players out there tonight. Thomas Hickey to center. And back in the Florida ice. Kulikov ahead, bats it to center. Hickey on it, and he'll fire it back in. Anything you see just over 2 minutes in, Ray?
Yeah, no room. Nowhere to go. Everybody's getting the puck, and if they don't have a clean look with it, they just chip it up the boards. Everybody's trying to be really safe with it. There's a good example of it.
So if there's nowhere to go, we're not going anywhere.
Well, it always happens. Something like this.
Pocket pick, but there's DeHaan up at center. Shane Prince, Nick Coleman. He'll play it in behind the net, and Prince is there. A goal in game three. Boychuk a whack at it. Ricochets DeHaan, and it's tipped low wide of the net. Off the stick of Brock Nielsen. Centering it. Nobody home, and the puck comes outside the line. Yager on it, taken down by Boychuk. And that Panther bench erupts, but White carries on.
Ooh, that was close. Yager was on his way on a 2-on-1.
Now up ahead. Was that stick on stick, or
there was a lot of body contact there. A lot of body contact there.
3.5 minutes in. Here's Letty to work. Lot more ice than anybody else. Helped orchestrate the tying goal. A shot on, and he gets the rebound behind the net. Now Tavares takes over. Letty's with him. Opozo behind the goal line as well. Tavares tied up by Matheson. Cut loose. And played back in where Matheson still locked up with Tavares. And it comes out and down the ice. A race for it, and the Islanders win it to force the icing call.
After the puck hopped by Boychuk, well, he pretty well tackles Yager's stick. Yager's going to lift the stick. Look at the arm sweep Yager.
And watch the Panther bench.
They had as good a look as anybody. But Gerard Gallant still not very happy. I think he's got a case.
Theme of the series, how even it's been. The faceoffs, 34 apiece with this defensive zone draw won by Trocheck.
Nobody's won two games in a row. There's just not much to choose from between these two teams who are just battling so closely.
Underrated series when it started, but pretty entertaining stop. Cizikas is in, swings wide. Casey Cizikas centers, shot, and it hit traffic in front and didn't get to the net. And the Panthers clear. Is this enough for icing? No. Logan Shaw crashing in. Puck played ahead along the board. Shaw after it, but Cizikas arrives first. He's tied up, but the Islanders come away with it, and Prince got a lot of jump, sends it back in. Shane Prince on it, played it toward the net, and Kulikov there. Luongo was a little slow getting there, and Kulikov may have saved the goal. On that bad angle centering pass. Now back in, Brock Nielsen unable to take that, and he's offside at the line.
Cizikas is going to drive wide around the net. Cal Clutterbuck's back behind everybody. His shot hits Gudbranson and Martin in front of the net. You see Martin driving the net. Luongo's trying to find it. Oh, it hits Gudbranson. And then Luongo, who's never been a great puck handler, hands this right to the Islanders. Gets some help.
Trying to play that fake off Luongo, who was coming across a little late. So past 5 minutes of the first extra period. Up off the skate to Huberdeau, rolling down, and DeHaan after it with Yager in his rearview mirror. Up along the boards, it's cleared by Klein. There's Kulikov firing it back in. Saw Thomas Hickey jump up to win game three. Does a defenseman make the difference tonight? Here come the Islanders. Tavares loose. Backhand off Luongo, and he gets bumped as Klein with a flyby in front afterwards. Centered. Luongo, another big stop. And another chance for Opozo. And now back come the Panthers. It's Trocheck over the line. His shot off the stick and out of play. Islanders coming close.
Really nice play. Quine to Oposo, and look at Tavares snap this backhander up over top of the net. He had a lot of heat on that. He's going backwards, and he's able to sling this up. Actually catches the side of the mask of Luongo up over the net. And then Oposo with a chance. Oposo's been here 8 years. Tavares has been here 7. They've had a lot of disappointment in their time. It almost ended right there.
Talk Kyle Oposo the other day about how this team should have gone on a run last year, how they're trying to atone for it. Shots are 6-1 Islanders here in overtime. Aaron Ekblad to the near side, those young defensemen. Ekblad and Matheson paired together with the heat on here in the extra session. Up ahead, Nielsen redirects to center, and there is the Calder Trophy winner, Ekblad, playing it back in. Kuhlman back to get it, and now he'll defer to Letty. Around to the far side, it gets past Matheson, and Logan Shaw back to get it in a hurry. Here comes the Place Bay Nova Scotia product, going all the way and trying to tuck it in, and Grace shuts it down.
Shaw saw some open ice, and when he wheeled with the puck, he's able to attack. Now, the Islander defense has to retreat. Really strong move by Shaw, and Grice makes a nice play to control the shot and then swallow this rebound so it doesn't go anywhere. There's no further danger.
Ray Shaw with under 10 minutes in the double overtime and under 10 minutes tonight, that maybe Gerard Glent goes a little bit more to a guy who skates well like him with fresh legs. Campbell along the boards, McKenzie plays it deep. Now the Panthers will try and cycle it down against the Islanders. McKenzie up high, Brian Campbell a shot wide, and off the ricochet, Hickey will clear. Jack Nelson to the Panther line and gets the puck again, and this time he'll dump it deeper. Petrovic hit by Martin on the forecheck, but McKenzie helps him out and clears. Johnny Boychuk dumping it in, and Kuhlman proceeded the puck into the zone, offside the call.
Well, the Islander bench was right in the linesman's ear on that one. The Islanders 4 or 5 times in this period of first period of overtime, Chris, have flipped the puck up in the air. Here's another one. As usual, 99% of the time, those guys get it right.
Kulikov from long range, and Grice drops it down. Malvin DeHaan flips to center, another one of those long alley-oops.
Like a pooch punt. They get it up the ice and then attack to where they think the puck's going to be.
Nielsen, and a good hit there by Kulikov. Stopped him in his tracks. Here comes Jágr. Jágr shooting blocked. Wide it goes, and Kuhlman with an outlet. Shane Prince with speed. Hook check there by Gudbranson, and a finishing hit from Kulikov. Gudbranson up the wall looking for Jágr. Letty tried to cut him off, but the puck played past him. Excuse me, not Letty, but Oposo. And there's Oposo to redirect back into the Florida zone. Tavares up in it, but gets up with the puck. Tracked by Kulikov up high. Threw it at the net. And stop off the Panther logo by Luongo.
I'll tell you, one guy that's energized after scoring late in the game, under a minute left, is John Tavares. In this overtime, he's been all over the puck. Just missed with the backhand earlier there. He gets to the loose puck, and he's just shooting this, hoping for a deflection somewhere. But you see the Islanders have sailed past the front of the net, and Luongo just pulls it into his belly.
Shots in the game, 39-33 in favor of the Islanders. Trying to make it closing time tonight. Panthers want to play on Tuesday night. Scooped on the backhand to the side of the net. Prince with it, cycles it in behind. A centering pass picked off by Trocheck, and the Panthers play it out. Big hit there on Jokinen, and a delayed offside as the Islanders tag up and now make a change. Ekblad ahead, redirected in off Jokinen. Panthers get fresh skaters out. We're 9 minutes into overtime. Good for Brian Campbell back. Around for McKenzie. Over Atlanta Thrasher up the wall, and now they'll have to regroup once again. Campbell to Petrovic. Tried to hook up with Logan Shaw on the right wing. That doesn't work. And once again, Campbell back to retrieve. And the Islanders make a change. Up off Logan Shaw. Able to redirect it. Garrett Wilson out there. Here's Barkov taking a shift with the fourth liner Wilson, who now makes his way to the bench. Barkov fires, and a blocker stopped there by Grace. Now it's Huberdeau. Barkov shot, and it's blocked. As Purcell can't get it through. Purcell after it again. A pair of goals in the series. Both were icebreakers. Trying to score a deciding goal here. Works the corner. Barkov awaits. Center in front. The Branson shot it high with a sprawling Grice. Kulikov holds it in. Up high, Teddy Purcell. And off the skate to Barkov, who can't control. To the line, but out. And offside called. Gudbranson not sure about it. We're past the midway mark of the first overtime period. And a timeout in Brooklyn.
Last shift, absolute bedlam in the Islander zone. Barkov tries for Huberdeau, and then when Zydlinski runs into Grice, he ends up about 8 feet in front of the crease on his belly. A great opportunity for Gudbranson, and he just airmails it over the net. Earlier on, that's the Barkov one-timer. The Thomas Grice continues his excellent play and makes the blocker stop.
Superb throughout the series. At the other end, Roberto Luongo looked like he was on his way to a shutout tonight till the final minute. Luongo said earlier in this series that his young teammates were quickly realizing how hard it is to win. And boy, are they getting an advanced course in that here in this playoff round. First time in history, two teams that have gone over 20 years without a playoff series win have collided. Islanders trying to end 23 years of frustration tonight. Florida hoping to take it to game seven and winning for the first time in two decades. Pretty compelling stuff here. The shots, 7-4 Islanders in the overtime session. Around to Kulman. Watched by Riley Smith. Hottest shooter early in this series. Riley Smith, but here's Kulman. Down in behind the net it goes. Jussi Jokinen gets back for it. Unable to clear, knocked down by Steve Bernier. Franz Nielsen, the center on this line for the Islanders. Can't think of a better birthday present he could give himself than a game winner here tonight. Of course, by the time this is done, it might not be his birthday anymore. Nick Leddy to work. Great series for Leddy, breaking through. Here's a Matt Martin shot right on. Cizikas collects the rebound. Tries the center, that's denied. Tried it again, doesn't work. Boychuk fires it wide. Purcell up with a puck, and he'll circle back. Ekblad ahead, deflected out by McKenzie. And away goes Shaw. Important shift now for these lesser lights, the fourth line and third liners. Need to give the big boys time to recoup. And maybe they'll play hero tonight. Knocked down at center. There's Barkov. Fed ahead off Tavares. And Luongo out of the net. Around it goes for Huberdeau. Nearly cut off. It gets to Tavares. He'll swing it across through the skates of a wide open Kyle Pozo. That was almost curtains for the Panthers. Pozo knocks it down at center. High stick is the call.
Oh, Pozo looks straight up to the top of the building as he's on the far side of the net. Tavares shoots this. It bounces off of Luongo's stick and right through his feet. Oposo is open, but the puck is deflected by Luongo and harmlessly through Oposo's feet.
He's been all around it tonight.
Oh, the Islanders are going to lose Johnny Boychuk here. Looks like a skate issue. He's just wandered across the ice. He might have a broken holder, the plastic part of his skate. He's gone down the tunnel. You see him walking with the equipment guys back to the Islander room.
Boy, that's important. A top four defenseman for the Islanders. Gone for at least a few shifts. See how good the Islander pit crew is. Brock Nelson shot right off the logo. Rebounded by the ball. Oh, what a chance for Shane Prince. It doesn't go. Panthers testing their nine lives here. Nelson back in. Shot. And Roberto Luongo's got it. And Shane Prince must wonder if he'll get another chance as good as that.
Well, if you're the Islanders and you get the daily double of Alan Quine and Shane Prince, back-to-back overtime game winners. Oh, what a great chance. The puck bounces on the rebound wide, and then on the second two-on-one, Aaron Ekblad plays this beautifully. He wants to go to Prince. Look at Ekblad aggressively across. He knows he's got backside help from Trocheck after Prince's miss. Nelson's shot is stopped, and the overtime continues.
Tavares on the draw. Won by the Islanders. Oposo back out there. Kyle Oposo with 13 shot attempts in the game. Here's a give and go, and a puck rolled in front. And Oposo well tied up in front. Panthers get it out. Logan Shaw chips, and he'll chase Sagit Jedlicki. Third pairing out for the Islanders with Thomas Hickey and Jedlicki. Tavares ahead. Oposo checked. McKenzie played it on a offside. They're going to have the faceoff outside the Islander line. Islanders thought it could have gone down deep on an intentional offside.
McKenzie felt that the Islanders brought the puck back in. That's why he was arguing. So Shane Heyer, the veteran linesman, standing just outside the blue line.
Under 7 minutes remaining in the first overtime period. 96 minutes Friday in game five. Here's a chance for Bernier. Fires, and Luongo got a piece of that. Steve Bernier in his 70th Stanley Cup playoff game. Just his second of this series. Off the center, knocked down by Hamonic. Ahead it goes for Jágr. Lurking at the Islander line to Huberdeau. In deep for Barkov and Jágr. What a storyline of 68 ends it. Barkov, Huberdeau, bad angle across and off a skeet. That ricocheted wide off Clutterbuck. Panthers get back on it. That's Ekblad in deep. Four Panthers to the attack. Jágr to the side of the net. Hands off to Huberdeau. Looks for Jágr, give it go, deflected in, and Grice had it underneath him and covers. That nearly leaked through.
I saw some really good examples of Jágr using his size and strength. You just can't push him off the puck. He leaves it for Huberdeau, and then a quick tight turn back to the plate. That's well played in front of the net by Franz Nielsen. Nielsen doesn't chase the puck. He keeps his body between Jágr and the goal, yet it still takes an excellent right pad stop from Thomas Greiss to keep the game tied.
34 stops for Greiss. 41 saves for Luongo. And we play on in Brooklyn. Letty switches it around, deflected by Prince out. Away goes Matt Martin. His shot gloved, and it will be covered by Luongo. These faceoffs so important now. Friday night, the second longest game in the history of both these franchises. Of course, the Panthers lost the Stanley Cup in a triple overtime decision in 96, and there was that marathon between the Capitals and the Islanders way back when. In the 80s, that was the longest ever. David Pollock ended the second longest one for the Islanders until Friday night. Lines on the ice. Back again with Tavares and Opozo. Centering pass. Back it comes to Hamonic. Plays it back towards the net, but the Panthers are on it. And they'll work it to the line, but not much further. Ryan took a hit, got it back in. Opozo again. He's dancing. Centers it. Jokinen there. Doesn't clear. Yeah, that puck deflects. Nobody saw where it went, and it just goes over the glass out of play as Trocheck has worked with Hamonic at center.
I don't want to be wasting any extra energy, and with a scrum, Hamonic and Trocheck are on the ice a lot. Back to the bench, get some air, and go right back out.
Now Derek McKenzie's had a good night. Needs another faceoff win against Nelson here, and pulls it right back to Luongo, who has to sweep it away. Flipped in by Hudler. Gary Hudler's been through the Stanley Cup playoff wars, a cup winner in 08. There's a shot that doesn't get through. Swept to the far side. Trying to play the bank off the end boards there, but that doesn't work.
Shane Prince is in a pretty good deal of distress here after blocking that last shot.
No sign yet, I don't believe. A Boychuk returning?
No, not yet, and I don't see him over where he would come out of the tunnel either.
Matheson sent it in. Gulovin trying to clear it. Good pass ahead. Trying to spring Cizikas. Slowed up at the line and now sends it in. There's Alex Petrovic. He lost the puck and it's clubbed down by Cizikas. Shot! And a toe stop by Luongo. Ricochets out to center. Now it's DeHaan. Deflected in by Kuhlman. Nielsen on the forecheck. The 51's after it as Campbell plays it to the line and out. Hamonic turns at the red line and bounces it back in. Under 4 minutes remaining in the first overtime session. Next goal wins. And here comes Tavares, who got the last goal. Stop, shot, and Luongo may have got a piece of that up onto the netting and out of play.
The Panthers have had one shift in this overtime in the 16 and a half minutes where they've controlled the puck. That was the Huberdeau-Barkov-Jagr line. They had a couple of chances on it. But for the most part, the Islanders look a little bit more lively.
Tavares over 28 minutes. Kyle Opozo close to 29 minutes. And they're back out there again for an offensive zone faceoff.
Tampa Bay is loving this. The longer, the better.
Play on, they say. In Tampa Bay, glove stop by Luongo. They'll do it again. By the time this series is over, Strowman and Stamkos might both be ready to come back.
On this side of the ice, Opozo takes the draw. He wins it back cleanly, and Hamonic's shot is deflected up over the net, but Luongo able to catch it.
So Opozo to take the draw once again. Islanders have had the best of the faceoff circle in overtime, and now have won seven more draws with another by Opozo there. Picky shot, blocked en route. Good Branson in the shooting lane. And a nice in call. We'll get another faceoff. When will this bite the Panthers?
It's an unfortunate icing for the Panthers. It was a good breakout pass. However, Jussi Jokinen had broken his stick. He didn't have a stick. It went right by him down the ice. He's just getting a new stick now and going to rejoin the play. Jack Capuano still leaving Tavares, Oposo, and Quine on the ice here.
So Tavares to take the drop. And from the scrum, the Panthers control. Tavares gets it back. Got to ward off the checking of McKenzie. Turns away, cuts to the front, spins, shoots, and fired it wide. Well, that would have been highlight reel material. Back in they come. It's a big climb. Shot it high. Oh, he had top corner. And now the other way. Here comes a pass. McKenzie blocked it away by Grace. Quick counter there by the Panthers. What a chance for Alan Quine. It's Jagr behind the net. Leaned on by Letty. Huberdeau reaching in, trying to come away with the puck. Tied up there as they scrum along the end boards, and Barkov away with it. Out of the point. Flip toward the net. Jagr after at the corner. A pushback by the Panthers. Barkov shot. Doesn't get through. The Tavares line's been out a while, although Clutterbuck is out there. Pressure legs, but Tavares and Quine still on the ice. And the clear will keep them on the ice. An icing call and a face-off in the Islander zone.
Johnny Boychuk back from the Islander locker room. Here's Alan Quine break through the defense. He wants to go to the shelf. Luongo might get a piece of this. And then Tavares earlier, he loses Derek McKenzie. This is outstanding puck protection. Look at him drive the puck into the middle of the ice and just miss the right side of the net.
And Jack Capuano, he's had Tavares on the ice a long time and has to take his timeout. Timeout presented by Gatorade Frost. Play cool under pressure.
This is not a strategy. This is not a timeout of strategy. This is get some air.
A little oxygen on that bench.
Yep.
He extended the shift when he had an offensive zone face-off, and then the Panthers took it down the ice, and they had some zone time. So Tavares has been out a while, and he's got another draw to win.
That's an aggressive move by Capuano. He leaves him on the ice in the offensive zone. And you got a chance to win. Of course he's going to do it. But the puck spun back out, and then the Islanders couldn't get it out. Now they're trying to regroup here.
It's a lengthy 30-second timeout, isn't it?
It sure was. And interesting here that they're halfway through a change. So you have Quine, who's a natural centerman. He's on the left wing. He's out here with Clutterbuck. I'm pretty sure they haven't played too much together. And John Tavares is in the middle.
Tavares, 30 minutes, 26 seconds of ice time so far tonight. And he wins the faceoff. Played up ahead. Is that going to be another icing call? So no change yet. And they'll do it all over again in the Islander zone.
The official, Dan O'Rourke, here is yelling at Clutterbuck, let's get going. Is Clutterbuck stopped for... I'm not really sure what at the Islander bench.
Try anything you can get away with at this juncture.
Oh, absolutely. You can grab another 10 or 15 seconds.
And if there's a guy that can get away with it, I'm betting on Cal Clutterbuck. 2:01 left in the first overtime period. Another face-off win for Tavares. Let's see if they can get it out, get the change. Flip to the line, and now Quine's going to get off. And Tavares too. Puck deflecting high in the air, glove down. And so Jack Capuano's timeout works. They get fresh troops on the ice. And Nelson joins Clutterbuck and Prince. Seen a lot of different combinations tonight. And now we get another icing call that the fans here don't like. And neither does the Islander coach.
Brian Campbell took a rather odd route to this puck. Capuano not happy with it at all. And all of a sudden, the smooth skating Campbell lost a couple of gears. Now, Hamonic has not gotten off the ice after that last, that mess. And now Clutterbuck had jumped into the bench and Bernier went out. Now they got to get Clutterbuck out there. They have totally scuttled what was supposed to be a face-off with tired players in the Islanders' zone. Hamonic and Clutterbuck just got another 30 seconds.
Barkov on the face-off, wins the draw, shot blocked. Campbell sends it deep. In behind the net, Hamonic points forward against Huberdeau. Up with it, Barkov. Point for Petrovic, flipping it wide. Huberdeau trying to corral it there. Knocked away from him by Brock Nelson, and Petrovic tried to hold it in. Nelson brings it out. Huberdeau turns it back in. Jagr behind him, a quick shot, and glove stopped by Greiss. And only 65 seconds left in the first overtime period.
The Islanders finally get five fresh players on the ice. This has been close to 2 minutes. They've been stuck in their zone, icing the puck, not getting fresh bodies on the ice.
So it's Trocheck and Cizikas to duel. Trocheck tried to go forward, but the Islanders up with it. There's Kulovic. And here's Nielsen over the line. Nick Leddy shot to the club. Stop. And a beauty by Luongo.
There was some outstanding work A to Z on this play. Kulovic's pass to Nielsen. Backhand feather to Leddy. A terrific shot. And there's Roberto Luongo with the glove stop. Really well played by Kulovic. He was squared off on the boards here. He turned backwards, found Nielsen in the middle, who found Leddy, and Luongo makes the stop. His 46th.
10-goal scorer last year. Leddy has not scored in the postseason in his last 17, but has some offensive talent. Plays in the slot. Bouncing puck. Nielsen shot wide. Panthers send it to center. Jokinen in the rest of the way. Trocheck first in on the forecheck and knocked the stick out of the hands of Grace on the flyby. So Grace without a stick. Hamonic plays it back to him. Campbell moves up. Trocheck looking to center. Leddy will work him over along the boards. And it comes loose for Tavares. Dying seconds of this overtime period. Tavares to the bench. And it's last call here in the fourth period. Sent down on a funny hop off a stanchion. Comes down for Barkov. In behind the net. Played to the point. And Plant shooting it. Where is it? Grace has got it. And the horn sounds. And we played 80 minutes without a decision.
I think there's going to be a second and a half or so added onto the clock here. The puck is worked well by the Panthers to Ekblad at the point. Look at the traffic that Greiss has to fight through. Huberdeau trying to get right to the front, but Greiss with the stop.
Good eye, second and a half for sure. And that is time, isn't it?
It could be. I mean, if you win it clean.
Is Jarek Gallant going to pull Roberto Luongo? He gestured down to the goaltender. There's time to score at one end, probably not time to score at the far end. And this is interesting, isn't it?
Yeah, you're not going to get it down the ice in 1.7 seconds.
So Luongo to the bench, an extra attacker for Florida.
This will be Trocheck trying to draw this to Riley Smith. Oh, he may look, you know what, the way he's set up, he may go to Ekblad on the boards for his shot.
Got three wide to the right, face off one, tip back, but time expires for the second consecutive game in the series. We'll hit the double overtime. Stay tuned for the Subway Overtime Intermission Report. Catherine Hansen, and again, our special guest tonight, Corey Schneider, as Roberto Luongo and Thomas Greiss stand strong here 1-1 through four periods in game six.
So welcome to the show. Bring on all the lights. Let it shine on you. We're together here tonight. Welcome to the show. Welcome to my life. Welcome to the show. Welcome to my life.
Has not solved it. And we press on.
Been a couple overtime games in this series. The Islanders have won them both. There's Thomas Hickey, 12 and a half minutes into game three. And the Islanders won in the last game. Alan Quine on the power play, a one-timer. That's 36 minutes into overtime. We're 20 minutes in now. About ready to tee it off for the second overtime.
Who's the hero tonight? The goaltenders have been heroic. Some interesting ice times, Ray. You've got a lot of star players like Tavares, Barkov, Opposo over 30 minutes. But then you've got a guy like Yuri Hudler who played one shift in the first overtime period, under 10 minutes tonight. And we were reflecting back to the 1990 Stanley Cup Final when Peter Klima sat for a few hours and then came out and won a game of triple overtime. Does Gerard Gallant play that card?
Toughest part for the coach is to trust again when you've sat a player for so long, is to trust that he can do the job when he goes back out there.
And with that in mind, there's Johnny Boychuk, who missed almost the entire first overtime with a skate issue. Came back late but never got on the ice. He's out there now. Barkov's line starts for Florida, and they push the puck in front of the net. It's late to the point, and a shot drilled wide. To the near side for Matheson. He'll send it deep again. Look at Jagr trying to ward off the checking of Calvin DeHaan. Swung in front. Huberto trying to knock down the rebound and get it on his stick. Jagr brings it down. Jaromir Jagr again. Swivels it in front, and no redirection there. Huberto's got it, though. Good pressure early. Ekblad shot off a leg to the near side boards. Oh, and Bernier plays it down the ice.
Sorry, Chris, that shot hit Jagr in the left knee. He is in all kinds of pain going to the Islander bench, or going to the Panther bench.
No weight on the right leg as he finally climbs in. John Tavares checks back in. Up ahead is Hamonic, flipping it high, and Opposo looks for it on the far side. There's Riley Smith. 8 points in the first three games, and now the last two and a, almost four, three games now, he's gone without a point. Had a chance in overtime, and for an empty net, now a crossbar here for Riley Smith. Oh, that is close to ending it.
He didn't take much time to spin and shoot that. It beats Grice right off the crossbar. There's the shot from Smith up over the off the crossbar and up into the netting. There's Jagr getting some help on the Panther bench. You see how he's struggling to get in. Getting some help from Jonathan Huberto. It was a point shot from Ekblad. Hit him in the left knee. He's testing it out on the bench just a couple of feet away here.
From the draw. Islanders clear. Deflected out to center ice. Matt Martin trying to get after it, but Gudbranson beat him to it. Riley Smith at center. Turns back for the smooth skating Brian Campbell. Veteran Campbell in, and a shot flagged down by Grice.
Jagr giving it a little test. He looks like he's okay. There's the slap shot, and it catches him in the left knee and ricochets all the way to the other side of the ice. Looks like he's okay as he took a quick spin.
And we mentioned Yuri Hudler, 24 on the ice here for his second shift of overtime. Logan Shaw on the draw, wins it, and they try to play it back to Petrovic, but jumping on that and sending it away was Steve Bernier. Ekblad off Hudler, and deep into the Islander zone. Logan Shaw with Teddy Purcell and Yuri Hudler for Florida. And the Islanders have Steve Bernier on the ice, along with Shane Prince and Brock Nelson. Petrovic wanted to reverse it. The Islanders were there, and now it gets knifed away just in the nick of time. Shane Prince plays it back in, and Alex Petrovic sends it across. Puck alley-oop towards Logan Shaw, and the Islanders reclaim it. Jaromir Jagr back out there, so he doesn't miss a shift.
Chris, the Panthers are without Dmitry Kulikov. He's not on their bench, so down to five defensemen for them.
Jagr with the steal, trying to work his way out in front. Johnny Boychuk stays with him, knocked the puck loose, and away goes Opozo. Took a look to see if anybody was with him. And off the feet to Campbell. Gloved down by Opozo to hold the zone. Campbell to the far side, Tavares in slipstream. And Thornton takes a turn in overtime. Didn't see a shift in the first overtime period. But after double overtime the other night, they need all hands on deck now. Here is Letty, nearly giving it up, but working it inside the line. And the Panthers come back to reclaim. Out at center, drifted in, and Luongo had to move quickly on that long-range attempt.
Chris, you've mentioned a couple of guys that haven't played very much. Corey Schneider was talking in the studio about the mental game for the goalies, that as much physical as it is to keep yourself sharp, to think through the play. And when you're sitting on the bench as a skater and you don't get your number called for a long time, it's pretty easy to wander. But you have to try and stay as sharp as you can. You get called here, you cannot obviously make a sleepy mistake.
From the draw, won by Trocheck. I asked Garrett Wilson and Logan Shaw if they were tired after the double overtime, and they smiled and said, well, we only played 10 minutes, but it was tiring watching. They've been active, or more active tonight, although we haven't seen much of Garrett Wilson, but Shaw's a guy that has shown some jump.
Well, if Vincent Trocheck isn't in shape after missing a month with a broken foot, he's going to be after these two games. He played 31 minutes the other night, and here we are in the second overtime again.
Just under 29 minutes so far. What a season he's had. Pittsburgh area product ready to take this draw against Nielsen. To the right of Grace, and Nielsen prevails. Letty pushes it around, kept in by Ekblad, threw it toward the net wide. To the near side, Matheson took a whack at it. Jokinen up with it, and a weak shot steered away by Grace. Ekblad steps up again, behind the net, Jokinen. Ekblad's moved up. In front was Riley Smith. Now Smith corrals the pass. Played back to Matheson, left point. He'll send it wide of the net. And the Islanders up with it. And out comes Travis Hamonic.
And Matheson's broken his stick on that initial shot, so he's going to try and scramble off here.
And he will get to the bench as Trocheck goes to the attack. He'll drop it off. Hudler shot it wide. Yuri Hudler with a rare look, and now Cizikas back. Three Islanders are in. Prince's shot off the glove of Luongo and swept to the corner. Try to center it there. Shane Prince was loose, but now back out comes Florida. It's Hudler through center. He'll flip it into the corner. Purcell goes after it against Thomas Hickey. Hudler trying to come up with a 31-goal scorer last year. A veteran of these Stanley Cup battles. Logan Shaw in support. Now Purcell behind the net. Centered. Jam play for Logan Shaw side of the net. Shaw in the corner. Upended there as he put it across. Here comes Campbell firing it wide. Had a little room, and it looked like Grace was screened. A breakout for Prince, but he was out of gas. And sends it deep. Opozo nearly came up with it. Takes Petrovic to the corner, but out comes Jagr. Striding through center, lost possession of it. Barkov tried to sweep it off the stick of Boychuk. Here comes Opozo in front of the net, but Klein can't get a shot. Islanders trying to keep it in, but it rolls to center as Opozo couldn't reach it in time. Tavares, Opozo, and Klein again up against Barkov's line. Boychuk with a hit on Big Barkov. Now the Islanders change, and in turn, Florida starts one as well. Riley Smith back to work. He'll send it around. Jokinen on the far side, clubbed down by Gudbranson. He'll hold it in. Good seal by Gudbranson. Smith to Jokinen. For Trocheck, and that shot is blocked. Panthers get it back. Gudbranson, a shot, and that went wide. Matheson holds it in. Far side, in front, Trocheck banned on it, and then couldn't reach the rebound. Pretty good spot for Trocheck. Pressure here, and Trocheck's on it again. Back to the point, and across. Gudbranson rolls it into the slot, and the Islanders are on it, and Brock Nelson gets it out to get a change. 7 minutes into double overtime. Matheson ahead, deflected off a stick. Sean Thornton gets another chance. Wouldn't it be something if a guy like Sean Thornton, an unlikely hero, but we've had unlikely heroes in this series. Thornton in on the forecheck as it's played back out. Petrovic ahead. Garrett Wilson with Thornton. Thornton has won a pair of cups with Anaheim and Boston. But here's Matt Martin away. Red line and drops it in. He'll try and get a hit on Campbell with a good one. Puck is centered, but getting back in a hurry is Logan Shaw. Campbell absorbed the hit and sends it ahead. Off Garrett Wilson to the Islander line. Opozo calls for it, gets it, works his way in. Oh, he nearly had Petrovic beat. Gets to the side of the net and can't get it in front. Now it's Klein. Does he double dip in double overtime? Nick Leddy down low. Leddy with it along the boards. Backing him up is Tavares. They'll scrum there, and the puck will be cleared out. Tavares sends it back. Both teams changing. Opozo stays out on the forecheck, and now he'll head to the bench to complete the change.
First overtime, the Islanders had the lion's share of the chances. This second one, it's been the Panthers that have controlled most of the play.
Michael Matheson to work. In deep after it. Pinned along the boards, but Jagr collects it. Turns it back, centers it in front. Bouncing puck. There's Gudbranson. And it's chopped at and goes over the glass. And out of play.
Well, the Panthers, as I mentioned, have had most of the zone time, most of the chances. Johnny Boychuk's going to slam this off the boards, and it turns into a three-on-two for the Islanders. Opozo's got it wide open, but the pass is about a foot and a half behind him. He tries to take it with his right foot and kick it up to his stick, and the scoring chance goes away.
48 saves for Luongo, 41 stops for Grice. 6-2 the shots, Florida, in this second overtime period. From the draw, Huberdeau on it. Jonathan Huberdeau for Jagr. Reels it back with that long reach. Barkov to the point. Matheson back in. Barkov there. Knocked down in front was Jagr. Played to Ekblad at the near side point. Fumbled the puck. And now back at center. It was retrieved by Kuhlman. Shift's getting shorter in length. Kuhlman trying to bust through. Knocked away. Huberdeau at the end of a shift will fire it in from the red line to complete a change.
Not only are shifts shorter, nobody is saying anything on the bench. This is energy recovery mode. No chirping back and forth. You just sit here and wait for your turn.
Ah, this is what the Stanley Cup playoffs are all about. Riley Smith can't get it through. Blocked by Hamonic. Matt Martin hit along the boards. Kept in by Petrovic. Sent deep. On a Trocheck. Back to Petrovic. And that intercepted by Hamonic. Nearly gave it away. Oh, Jussi Jokinen had a lane to the net. but couldn't control it. Past the midway mark of the second overtime period, so we're 90 minutes deep. Once again, Logan Shaw after it against Jedlicki, and gotta be careful there. Nearly got the grab on Jedlicki. Rink wide it goes. And now sent a hit, kicked up by Opozo. Tavares, pad stop Luongo. Tavares, now scores! John Tavares, and the 23-year wait is over!
If you're lucky enough to draft a cornerstone player, you hope to get into a position where you can see his true brilliance. What a spectacular effort from John Tavares after Roberto Luongo had made a brilliant pad stop. Tavares collects the puck. And dives around the net to end the series and a 23-year drought for the New York Islanders.
He tied it and he wins it. And there's no unsung hero tonight. The superstar took care of business.
What a fabulously played series. The Panthers played so well in this series. So many young players that have so much to look forward to. What a disappointment for them. But the New York Islanders will advance to the second round of the playoffs for the first time in 23 years.
The Islanders said they'd learned from past disappointments, and this is a hard lesson for the young Panthers who will be back. But the New York Islanders, with three overtime wins, a pair in double overtime, have advanced to take on the Tampa Bay Lightning. John Tavares with his fifth goal of the series, officially from Opozo and Klein at 10:41, a double overtime. And Thomas Greiss, how heroic was he in this game and in this series? His first ever as a starting goaltender in the playoffs. Let's go down to ice level. Here's Ray, and the hero of the series.
John, what was more incredible, the last minute goal or the overtime goal?
I don't know, it seemed like we saved it for the second half of the third in overtime. We seemed to find our legs, a jump, and you know, I just tried to get lost and puck came kind of through to me, and it's funny how it works sometimes.
When you're sitting in the locker room between the overtimes, are you thinking at all, I got a chance, it can be me?
Yeah, for sure. I think, you know, you think about their situation, how hard they work to get that opportunity. And, you know, we fought right to the end and tied up. We knew we had some momentum. We got the crowd going. Just wanted to feed off it and get these fans a series win.
This is pretty incredible. Great luck to you in the second round.
Thank you. All the best.
23-year wait is over, and the Islanders' new home is rocking in Brooklyn. A pair from Tavares, who has 12 goals in his last 15 games, maybe the most underappreciated superstar in the National Hockey League. Another look at the wraparound, the quick hands, and the finish. Ray, we talked to him this morning and you just had a feeling he wasn't going to be denied here tonight.
Chris, about halfway through the third period, you said if the Islanders are going to score, it's going to be this line. Opozo, who played a heck of a game, makes the pass to Tavares. Look at how he sniffs out that rebound. He gets to it first. and Kyle Aposo, who's been here 8 years, Tavares, who's been here 7, there has been plenty of dread and plenty of heavy nights here for these guys. They get to celebrate on John Tavares' spectacular overtime winner.
Because of how late the night was, they added trains here for the fans to get home, and a lot more are going to be on the Islanders train after this series.
What a remarkable.
So close to a shutout here in Game 6, and John Tavares spoils the shutout and spoils the Panthers' first-round series.
It's been a long time for Jack Capuano as well. They've been through, as I mentioned, some pretty tough times. First year moving to Brooklyn. Watch the crowd.
The new home's already got some spectacular first-round memories, don't they?
They sure do. Look how excited. What a battle for them. Outplayed at times in this series. A spectacular series for Thomas Greiss in goal. And their captain and leader, John Tavares, comes up big in double overtime.
Time now for the three stars of the game, brought to you by Chase Freedom Unlimited.
What a performance by the goaltenders. Tavares, of course, with the game-winning goal, but Grice's series was outstanding. Roberto Luongo was brilliant in a losing cause.
Take one more look at the game winner here.
Nice pass by Aposo around Aaron Ekblad. Don't forget the Panthers played this overtime without Dmitry Kulikov, so they're down to 5D. They don't get to the loose puck off their Luongo's left pad save. The guy that gets it is John Tavares.
Our final score, Islanders 2, 4-1 in double overtime. Let's send it to Catherine in our studio for NHL Overtime.